Tonight, Mason Allen, Tommy Okami once again, but this time I'm healthy, I can walk, I'm ready to go. The undefeated, never to be defeated, keeps going. The Legacy Championship around my waist tonight.
Mason Allen, thought you could take this away from me. You want to play some games, going on crutches, and you ain't really hurt, huh? Almost got your boy Justin, and then whack, right in the back of those crutches. But after tonight, I think you might need those crutches for real. So I'll see you out there, sweetheart.
That's right. You're about to see the inaugural Wrestling Evolution Tag Team Champions right here, the OGs. Because why still we what?
We
what?
Fight smart, kids.
And we party hard because you're looking at those first ever champs. We're making history, baby. Oh yeah.
There is no other team out there that can carry this company into the future. The legacy we will carry on our backs. The Allen Brothers. There is no other team better than us. We are the best tag team here and in the Carolinas.
Tonight, we cement ourselves as the best. Allen's on top.
Wrestling Evolution, let me introduce you to a new power couple. Ken Magnum, Miss Exotic. Furio, Italian Steel's bulletproof. Good thing you're fighting the loaded gun.
All right, Pop. Frankie, look. Tonight, your newly crowned champ, your son, the young Italian lion, Don Furio, the magnificent Don Furio, we're going one-on-one against the loaded gun, Ken Magnum.
Magnum?
Magnum.
Magnum.
Magnum! Oh, look, the point is, he's riding in, but he's not riding in alone. He's going to have some assistance with him, so I need your eyes peeled, I need your ears open, I need you to be extra sharp here tonight, okay?
A posse?
Not a posse. Okay, look. It's going to be me and Ken Magnum, the first time, the last time, the only time. And we're out here to prove that Italian Steel is bulletproof here tonight at Wrestling Evolution.
All right, fans, welcome here to ringside for Wrestling Evolution Aggression for the love of wrestling. And speaking of love, what's with that hot pink tie you got going on there?
I don't know, Tim. What's up with your lime green Ninja Turtle tie you have
Ninja
on?
Ninja Turtle,
yeah. We're not even talking about my tie or your tie. We should be talking about the stacked card we have tonight. We have the crowning of the inaugural Tag Team Champions here at Wrestling Evolution. We also have my personal favorite wrestler, Mason Allen, finally getting his opportunity against that gigolo, that degenerate Tommy Okami. Oh, Kaitlyn Marie is here. Oh, boy.
Yeah, you're really excited about that.
Yeah.
And last month, we saw the crowning of the new Wrestling Evolution champion, Don Furio, and here he comes. All right, here comes our new Wrestling Evolution champion, Don Furio, along with Frankie.
Oh, come on, Tim. Let's be honest about something, Tim.
Okay.
Oh, Frankie, he's just looking for a meal ticket. And how low do you have to be? How much of a scumbag do you have to be to use your own son as your meal ticket?
Well, that's a little harsh.
Okay. Look at those new duds Don Furio has on. Okay.
Of course, he's the champ. He should have new duds.
Yeah, but what about Frankie? Huh? Frankie just with such grace and ease as he slides into the ring. Just
there he comes.
Yeah, he's gonna get there eventually.
Ladies and gentlemen,
makes me sick.
Give you the champ. How y'all doing? Man. I feel like Rocky Balboa right now. Like I should be on the cover of a Wheaties box or something, you know?
More like Cheerios. They're saying Cheerios. He's hearing that?
No, I think it's Furio.
Oh,
not Cheerios.
I'll start calling him Don Cheerio.
Cheerios aren't good for you.
No, they're not. They cause extreme gas.
Good for your heart.
There's a lot of people.
Yeah, and your rectum.
Rectum.
There's a lot of people.
Damn, you're killed
him. Thanks to. My pop, Fat Frankie, being one of them. Let's hear it for him. Y'all know you love him. And the second is every single one of you of Denver, North Carolina.
Oh, Frankie's taking
it. Probably gonna go pawn it.
I heard that one.
Bum.
Whoever said that. Stop catcalling me. Look, You guys showed a side of me that I didn't even know existed. So I want to thank every single one of you in the audience of Denver, North Carolina. Give yourselves a round of applause. And I even want to thank one more person. I want to thank you, Kenny.
Oh, well, that's kind of...
He pretty much called out Ken Magnum.
Why would you do something like that?
I'm not sure.
He's the loaded gun. We're talking about a 20-year veteran of the Indies, the East Coast legend, Ken Magnum. Please, please start raining. Someone hit the sprinkler. Hit the sprinkler, Tim.
It's okay. Settle down.
Hit the sprinkler.
All right, Ken Magnum looks like he's ready for battle.
Yeah, Ken always looks like he's ready
that
for battle.
That is true.
I don't think I've ever seen this guy smile. Oh, no, no, no. Come over here. Walk on the apron over here.
Settle down. I have to hose you down here.
You know, speaking of hosing,
the water action wouldn't be
bad around here. I could just spray the ring down, let everything just kind of calm down a little bit. You know what I'm talking about? Ken looks impressive. I mean, for someone that's been around for over 20 years, I mean, he stays consistently jacked. Multi-time champion. Oh, this is going to be good.
Denver, North Carolina, I don't expect you to know who I am, but by the end of the night, as God is my witness, you're going to find out exactly who Loaded Guns Ken Magnum and Miss Exotic is.
Not a lot of love being shown to Loaded Guns there, yeah. Tim.
There's a few things I've got to say to you, Donnie, and I hope you're ready for all of them. First, congratulations on your new Wrestling Evolution Heavyweight Championship. Secondly, I want to congratulate you on lasting 5 years in a real man's business.
Oh,
wow.
Oh, shots fired, Tim.
Because,
I love it.
You see, 5 years is chump change. In 3 weeks, I celebrate 20 years in this ring. Face it, Donnie, I've got more shower time than you've got ring time.
Oh, and that is true there, Tim Dixon.
Yeah, Ken Magnum is a veteran of this business.
Shut up. Speaking of showers, this is exotic.
That's your last warning.
You need to settle down.
All of that aside, I have been taking anger management classes. All of that aside, I'm going
to
keep the peace.
I dare your ass to say that to his face.
But you committed a cardinal sin, young man, with me. You see, nobody in my life have I ever.
Oh, boy.
Permitted to call me Kenny.
Oh.
Call me all you want, because when he steps into this ring with me later on tonight, your reign is short-lived, Donnie.
Oh, well.
Whoa. Kenny, calm down. It's not the 80s anymore, macho man, okay? Come in all mad. Good Lord, I thought you said you were taking anger management classes. It ain't working, bro. You look constipated up in here next to me, man. What's the deal?
I don't think this is going to help his anger management.
Everything aside, all competitiveness aside, every head must bow. You've been in this business 20 years, okay? You're still a loaded gun, even though he's been shooting blanks for years now, and we all know it.
Oh, boy.
I don't think this Exotic's going to appreciate that very much, Tim.
Yeah, I don't think this is going to help Ken's movement.
I will extend my hand in respect. And tonight, you know what? We're going to see who is the all-around cowboy. the magnificent Don Furio, Italian Steel, or the loaded gun, Ken Magnum. Italian Steel is bulletproof.
A handshake in the middle of the ring.
Some sportsmanlike condo.
Oh, wait a minute.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. I'm going to love this. Whoa, boy. Whoa. Here we go. Oh. Whoa, he almost.
Whoa.
He got out of the way of that super kick.
Hey, that was close.
That was real close.
Hey, but Ken Magnum, he's a student of the game. Speaking of anger management, look at Furio. He is
Furio is cranked up. Magnum making his way around the ring. And Don Furio is clocking him the whole way. All right, well, that got a little crazy.
Oh, my God, did it ever, Tim? Look, I was about ready to go under the table.
Like, under the table?
No, hobo.
Hobos?
Like vagrants, you know, like bums. They live in alleyways and under rocks. I stay the hell away from them.
Okay, well, whatever. The main event is set up for our championship match. And speaking of championships, have you seen the new tag team?
Oh, my God, they look outstanding. These are probably the nicest tag team championships I've ever seen. But you know what's so exciting is we've got comments from all the participants in the matches tonight. In fact, Tim, I think it's time
to take it to the ring.
Boom. I don't know why you like this referee, Phillips Peabody. But speaking of someone you should like, let's give it up for Justin Kindred. I mean, this is an honorary member of the Mason Allen collegiate family.
He's an honorary Allen.
Well, let's be honest. The real Allen is Mason Allen. The other Allens are just...
Are you saying the other Allens aren't real Allens?
I mean, you want to talk about the top of the top, the cream of the crop. It's always Mason Allen. I don't hear anybody talk. I don't see them getting legacy championship.
Well, they are in the finals for the tag team championship.
Yeah, thanks to. And thanks to who? Mason Allen.
Okay, I'll give you that.
Checkmate, sir.
And here comes Justin's opponent tonight, Stephen Meeks. He is a special individual.
Special individual. He just looks like he went through puberty. Are you serious? That's like 14 years of growth on his face. Rocking the man bun.
He's a very happy individual.
Yeah, you think?
Very mellow.
Yeah, when you're shrooming your balls off, I guess he would be happy.
Oh, it's a hug. Oh, he's a hugger.
Well, we are LGBTQ plus here at Wrestling Evolution.
Don't forget the plus. Oh, he wants a hug from... Justin. I don't think it's going to happen.
But how come we don't want a hug from old Philip Peabody up there and that goofy mullet?
No.
You know, let's just break down.
Justin is upset.
Yeah, let's just break this down, okay? You know, for some reason, there's a divide in the Masons about the standing for Justin. But, you know, Justin Kindred, you know, he holds his own out there. And you're going to find out right now here, where he just completely decimates Stephen Meeks, why he should be and will be an honorary Mason.
All right, Kindred and Meeks getting ready to tie up,
We've seen a lot of interesting and sporadic-looking body art, men with tramp stamps and all the like, but you know what, just like Myrick Morris, a lot of Wizard of Oz tattoos, but you see Stephen Meeks, he's got some goofy-ass tattoos of his own. I mean, none of them make any sense. They're all over his body in bizarre patches and places. Speaking of bat wings, okay? Speaking of bat wings, later on, we get to see the Legacy Championship be defended when my personal favorite wrestler and also compadre of Justin Kindred's, Mason Allen, goes one-on-one with that degenerate, that nasty, sycophant
Why do
Tommy
you have
Okami.
Such a problem with Tommy? He just loves people, and he...
So you're a fan of the bat wing, is what you're telling me?
I'm just saying...
The Gooch. Big Gooch fan you are. Okay.
I am a fan of
Would you
of
please
love.
Get your head in the game here?
For the love of wrestling.
Yeah.
Now, Kendra with Meeks back in the corner.
Oh, pulled his punk card.
Wow.
Just pie-faced him.
Uh-oh. The man bun's down. He's harshing his buzz.
You know, he took his man bun down. It kind of looks like Ricky Lake. Totally dating myself there. But
Ricky Lake?
Yeah.
Wow.
Look at that hair. I mean, that's the pre-inverted bob right there. I mean.
Nope. Oh, another hug for Charles Fuller.
Definitely pretty fruity. George South would love him.
Fruit. Well,
You see a mullet like that, you got to hug it. That's just all there is to it.
All right, so we got Ricky Lake in there and some late 80s country star in there. And then, you know, but hey, so I'm going to take a mullet. You know, Kendrick has one too.
Yeah, actually, yeah, he does. Oh, no, no hug. No hug from Justin Kendrick. Kendrick back in the ring now.
Oh!
Oh, big boot to
there
the stomach.
There we go.
Right into that side headlock.
That's right. You know, you could chop wood all day, but this is, it says wrestling, okay? It says wrestling on the marquee, okay?
Absolutely.
It doesn't say sitting there giving hugs, going out to the crowd and kissing babies and high-fiving fat chicks. It's about getting there, kicking somebody's ass, Tim.
All right. Well.
And if there's one that's probably ready to kick some ass himself, it's Justin Kindred, protege of my personal favorite wrestler, Mason Allen. I can't say enough good things about Mason Allen. It's been hard for me to concentrate tonight because Mason Allen finally gets this opportunity to dethrone Tommy Okami.
Well, he had his opportunity last month, but he decided he wanted to use that crutch in
well,
the match.
Hold on.
He gave his opportunity to Justin
Kindred. Why are you bringing
up old
stuff?
Because we were talking about his opportunity.
And, you know, if you don't think Mason Allen has what it takes to win the Legacy Championship,
I didn't say that.
I guess we'll find out who's right and who's wrong tonight because that match is going down shortly.
Yeah, I didn't say he didn't have the ability to take that championship.
Definitely going do-si-do here.
Stephen Meeks hanging from the ropes there. He's coming back up.
Yeah, skins the cat, catches him by the head with the leg scissors.
Now Kindred out to the outside, and Meeks
look
back into the ring.
That's two skin the cats. That's rare.
Goes
for the dive, lands
cats
in the apron.
Meeks, I don't know what Meeks has in mind here. Coming off of the apron.
Oh! Cactus Cracker from the apron to the floor.
And
shades of legendary Mick Foley. You know, and you got to give Philip Peabody some credit. He's out there checking on.
It's Charles Fuller. Mullet man.
Who?
The referee.
Which one's that? Talking about Philip up here?
That is Charles.
It's not Charles. It's Philip. Okay.
It's Charles Fuller. He just celebrated his 16th birthday.
You serious? Seriously?
Yes.
Speaking of, where's Josh Cash at? Where's senior referee Josh? Oh.
Josh Cash is not here.
Not
this,
here.
This month. He's taking some time.
Taking some time, huh?
To maybe
okay.
go to rehab.
Yeah, okay. Little. Wow, slingshots in for the DDT. They're right in front of
and
us,
here's
Tim.
Here's a cover.
You know, kick out of two, but, you know, Justin was right by the rope. I'm surprised that old Peabody there wasn't able to see that. You know, wrestling textbook 101, when your foot's under the bottom rope, that does count.
That is true.
Rope
yeah.
Oh! Look at the speed of Justin.
Kindred out of the way, and Meeks face first into the turnbuckle.
I mean, Justin's aggressive. Don't let him fool you. I mean, don't let the dad bod fool you. Oh!
Sharp clothesline.
Oh,
and
this could be
another
it.
Cover.
You
only
know,
a two count,
you know, Tim,
from Charles
Tim,
Fuller.
Tim, I'm looking around here. We got a packed house in here
yep.
tonight.
Absolutely.
You think Mr. Wilcox will give us a pay increase tonight?
I don't see
he
that.
He is the boss.
He is the boss, yeah, but I don't see a bonus coming.
Yeah, I don't see it either. I went to get a bottle. Oh. Wow.
I guess in a way.
I kind of just stopped whatever I was saying there.
Yeah,
he's going to do it again.
Oh, no, he's not. Meeks out of the way and handing out a chop of his own. And going to the other corner.
And this crowd is a sadist. They just want to see
it.
Chops over and over. Oh.
And we're going from turnbuckle to turnbuckle.
Kindred
able
to catch
him.
Turnbuckle. Wow, what ring awareness by Kindred. Oh, Kindred's picking him up. Oh, now he's about ready to get nasty out there. Scoop slam. Oh, almost dropped him on his head.
Watch the ceiling.
Yep. Here we go.
Kindred off the ropes.
Oh! Wow. That was incredible.
He's covering. Driving all the air out of Meek's body, but unable to get a three count.
You know, I gotta say here, Meek's has some fans out here. They're all wearing shirts that say ring rats. What the heck's a ring rat, Tim?
I don't know.
I've
heard of that.
I don't know. They all look a little young. got to see up my notes what that means real quick.
Don't Google that. Don't do that.
You told me the same thing about Tracy Lords. Why can't I
Google that.
I can't Google that. Can I at least do an image search for that?
No. Definitely not.
What about a video set?
No.
All right, well,
Meeks with shots to the midsection of Kindred off the ropes.
Wait, up. Wow. Go for the roll-up. Kindred went for the kitchen sink. Meeks had it well scouted. Wow, shoots the half. Oh, yeah, Justin holds on. These guys are having a phenomenal pace here.
Picked up the pace here.
Pick up the pace is absolutely
nice suplex.
Right. Suplex is right. That, that was beautiful. I loved it.
Oh. That was nice. He included you. He said that was for you, Asgard.
Well, broadcast journalist. I know exactly what I was. That was absolutely three.
That was not
come
three.
Come on, Peabody.
It's only two. And it's Charles Fuller.
It's Philip Peabody, okay? Stop. Yeah, I think you're getting him confused. Have you been drinking with Josh Cash? Do you need to go to the Hazleton Alcoholics Anonymous Clinic?
Oh,
wow.
Hard clothesline.
I think pandering to me might have cost him a little bit.
Yep.
A lot of movement going on here. Discus forearm. But Justin's still on his feet. He wraps him around. Oh, but look at, yes.
Side rush of
Lex. Yes, look at Kindred.
Wait
a minute.
Run him out of it.
How resourceful is Kindred? What ring awareness?
Nice submission. Stretching Meeks out. Charles Fuller right on top of it. Oh, but Meeks rolled him over. Now he's into a cover.
These guys are just like fish out of water in here, but eventually it ends up with something great.
Oh! Nice suplex again.
That's right, belly-to-belly suplex. Come on, Kindred. You know, I just got to say that, you know, I wonder if Mason is watching this match from the back.
Well, you have to think he is because, like you said, he's a protege of Mason Allen, so you know he's watching to provide feedback.
Ugh, I would not want to upset Mason Allen. We're talking about, yeah. Now it's like, whoa! It's like a novice being trained by an Olympian. Come on!
Oh, there's a three count.
Here's our winner, Stephen Meeks.
And Justin Kindred not able to get the job done against the debuting Stephen Meeks. Oh, he was going to give Fuller a hug, but he fell
down. Probably his breath.
Introducing first, making her Wrestling Evolution debut, from Tacoma, Washington, Leah Night!
Now one thing about Leah Night there, Tim, is she is all attitude. You thought Lexi Steele was a bitch.
Hey.
Oh, your buddy. I forgot, your buddy Lexi.
I told you, I'm a fan of Lexi.
Yeah.
And we'll see what Leah has to
offer. Oh, she's nasty. But you know what? I'm actually kind of excited about this. In fact, I'd like to do this real quick, Tim. Let's put a toast. Sorry about
drinking?
That.
All right, here comes Kaitlyn Marie.
Oh. Okay, hold on. I got to get another one. Hold on.
What are you drinking? What is that?
Well, smell.
Oh, my God.
Well, hey, oh.
What the hell is in there? You could light it.
Oof.
Oh, don't breathe over me.
Listen.
Good Lord.
Oh, yes.
Kaitlyn Marie is making her way around the ring.
Amazing talent she is. Oh, are you? Yeah.
Are you getting drunk?
She's already come by us here.
How many of those have you had?
What the hell?
God.
She did it again. Are you serious? She did.
Are you serious?
Yeah.
Sitting here drinking.
You didn't just hear that? What just happened?
I don't know what happened behind us.
I don't
know what you're doing.
Yes,
you're drinking and you're not offering me anything. That's the problem.
Wait.
You okay?
We've got Leah Knight and Kaitlyn Marie in the ring.
Yeah.
Why the hell does Leah not got to be over here by us? Can't she?
That's not Lexi, no.
So.
All right.
Yeah. Can we tell the referee to please switch positions of these two competitors so we can make a good analysis of the physicalities that might affect the competitiveness of this match. Now,
are you just stringing words together? What's going on? What?
You know, I'm a.
You got problems.
Oh, hold on. Give me one second. I got to put my microphone up. Hold on.
What are you doing? What are you drinking?
What's wrong? Look, why?
Listen.
Okay, so.
You were accusing me of hanging out with Josh Cash too much. Now what's going on over here?
You're not alcoholic. You're not alcoholic unless you admit it, Tim.
God. Well, that's not true. It's not how
what
it works.
A little handshake. Oh, no. Wow.
Oh, that seemed to light a fire in Kaitlyn Marie.
Oh, wow. That was a very nice aggressive headlock takeover. And that's one thing Kaitlyn doesn't like to be is humiliated.
Well, no. Who does?
No. Oh, amazing.
Oh, it's a cover.
Amazing. Wow. That's an amazing headlock. Wow, that's just...
It is.
Wow, that is just incredible.
You okay?
Form on the head. Yeah. Yeah, that's How are you?
I'm fine.
Okay, that's just... Okay, she's...
You got some problems tonight, man.
Wait, what?
Stay focused, all right?
Okay, yeah. Yeah, Kaitlyn's a great wrestler. I mean, she's got very good fundamentals and basics. And hold on, just give me like 1 minute
again
here.
Again with this? How many shots have you taken?
Sorry.
Oh, God.
Wow. Yeah, that was a
nice takeover.
Yeah, that was wonderful.
A little spank to go along with it.
Wait, what?
Are you okay?
Yeah, I'm trying to call a wrestling match, Tim. Come on.
Are you, though?
Wow, she's log rolling her around the ring. And
yeah, she has complete control of Leah
Knight.
Yeah,
total control. okay.
How many shots have you had?
When did the match start? Let's see.
It's just been a couple of minutes.
Five?
You have five shots in the last couple minutes?
Come on, it takes a while for that stuff to get your blood through.
No,
it's being approved there. Oh, that was effective. Stop being a prude, Tim. Come on. You and your Zimas. Wow. Beautiful fireman's carry over.
Oh, and Leah Knight decides it's time to go outside.
Yeah, she scrams right out of there before Kaitlyn Marie. Yeah, speaking of, they're taking a little break here. Let me just take a little break
Another?
Here.
Oh, good
just
Lord.
Just kind of you're going to be. You sure you don't want
to? No, I don't think so. I think I need to take it away from you.
What? What are you, my mom? How's my tie looking?
Your tie is looking horrible.
Hey, how's it going?
Oh, jeez.
How's it going? anyway, okay. Now, hold on.
Let's get back to the match here.
Yeah.
Now, Leah Knight back in the ring. Oh, a trip. Kaitlyn Marie as she ran in.
Oh! Wow!
Uh-oh.
Oh, she's going for the butt bump.
We got incoming.
Here we go. Oh! Are you serious? Come on!
You're an infant.
Me?
Yes, you.
Why are you... Those are those
cannonball!
Wow, cannonball
in the corner
on fire tonight.
And Leah looks out.
Oh yeah, like out on her feet. Hooks her up. Beautiful fisherman suplex.
Nice
with the
suplex.
Release. Kaitlyn is showing it all tonight.
Here's a cover.
That was a beautiful move. Beautiful. And let me just.
Well, here you go again.
Like to what? I'm thirsty. It's hot out here.
Oh,
I'm parched.
Thirsty,
come on.
All right.
Very parched.
Back
wow.
in the corner. Big splash.
Big splash by Kaitlyn. Oh, no.
She's hooking her up.
Oh, God.
Corner.
No. Oh, memory chop. Come on, Tim. Completely uncalled for.
Up.
Another one? Yes.
She's
yes,
asking
yes.
for another one.
Another one. Here we go.
Oh,
another
here
one.
We go with another
oh,
one.
Yeah.
Oh,
damn.
Oh, jeez. You're going to be in the floor before this match is
yeah,
over.
Yeah, what are you talking about? Wow, that was a...
You are losing it.
Yeah, I just, me?
Yes, you.
I'm a loser, huh?
No, you're losing it.
We're losing it? What are you talking about? Sitting right here. Oh,
you're making a mess over there.
Oh, right to the soloplex. Beautiful snapper over. Kick to the back. Oh.
And to the side of the face.
Oh, yeah.
Oh. Big leg drop in her cover.
Leg drop. This could be it.
Yeah. Knight able to get a... Her shoulder up before the three count.
You know, there hasn't been much offense from Leah Knight here, but Kaitlyn is, oh, no water in the pool, and just as I say that, Knight has the wherewithal to get out of the way and now just stomp her on the back of the spine.
Off the ropes.
No!
Drop kick to the
face.
Wow,
that was stiff. Here we go. Wow, not even a one count. Not even a one count. What resiliency by Kaitlyn. She's going for the bow and arrow, Chris, here. Kaitlyn gets one hand free. And speaking of one for free.
Oh, jeez.
What is the problem, Tim?
You've got problems. I think you need to. We need to get you
just
in the
one.
Same, no.
Just one.
No. I think we need to get you in the same place Josh Cash is this weekend.
Yeah, you know, he might be on extended vacation, Tim.
I think so, yeah.
Hold on. Just
get him dried
out. Just hold on for one second here.
Oh, jeez. All right.
Okay. Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Does it burn?
I'm feeling better and better as this match
sure
is going
are,
on.
Yeah.
I tell you, it's this quality of wrestling there, Tim.
I'm sure you are feeling better and better as you go.
You know, what's good for the goose is good for the gander. I'm a big fan of Kaitlyn here, but let's be honest about something. She was just wearing Leah Night out around here, and now it's fair play. And oh, my.
Knight with the good. Boot right to the, to the throat of Kaitlyn Marie. Settle down.
You can see that in my notes here. Just looking through the.
I don't think those are the notes you're looking at.
What? What are you talking about, Tim?
Right,
speaking of not looking, just can you look over there for a second, just real quick, just kind of step over there. Just look that
you're
way.
That's crazy. You know
what? I got.
I'm Kaitlyn Marie off the ropes.
Oh my gosh! She low bridger took
she
her legs
did.
Completely out.
Chopped her legs right
what
out from under.
Speed by Kaitlyn. I mean, she's deceptively a great athlete, and now she's starting to pick up the pace here. Oh! Oh!
Now off the ropes
wow,
again.
Kaitlyn is revving up the band. Oh, rolling cannonball. She is absolutely decimating
a cover.
Wow. Knight kicked out. That was incredible.
I don't know if Knight knows what to do here because Kaitlyn is on a roll.
Oh, yeah. You know, I think that match with Lexi Steele went a little fire under her ass, and now she's, you know, speaking of which. No. Wait, I was going to offer you what? You know what?
No.
Lighting a fire, okay?
Yeah, I'm sure you can light that on fire.
You know what? You make me sick, Tim.
Yeah.
Oh, wow.
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 Dropped her with a DDT.
Did you see the impact of Kaitlyn's head hitting the mat?
I'm shocked she was able to get her shoulder up.
I can't believe Kaitlyn's even conscious right now. Just dropped her strong style.
Right on the crown of her head.
And now Kaitlyn, and speaking of crown, have you ever had Crown Royal?
Oh, yeah, that's pretty good.
Oh, it's okay. You drink Crown
Royal.
I
like the bag. I don't do it while I'm working.
I'm sorry.
Stop that.
What?
Stop it.
Okay, look. This is the last one.
Yeah,
I promise.
Sure.
Okay,
because you run out.
Listen,
probably.
Listen. Tim, listen. Okay,
I'm listening. Hold
on.
Oh, jeez. I'm shocked you're still conscious.
Hey, listen.
I'm listening.
Tim, I love you.
Yeah.
I love you, man.
All right. You need to sober up. Somebody get me some coffee over here.
Coffee?
Yeah, we need some
coffee. Have
you
ever had coffee and Bailey's before?
Oh,
that's incredible.
That's the last thing you need.
Coffee and Bailey's. This is really good. All right, look. Let's get back into this. Okay, Kaitlyn now.
Back in the corner.
Oh, wow. Look at Rich in the arm.
Leah Knight wrapping her arm around the top rope.
Hold on. I ran out. I'm sure.
That's
all right, yeah.
Liquor bottles all over the place in here.
Well, see, where? You know where some is?
No, they're all empty.
No, that one is. Where the hell?
You drank it all.
Oh!
Yeah, Kaitlyn Marie eating a boot from Leah Knight.
And what's...
Again, another nice suplex.
Yeah, you know, the Leah's, her executions are so low that Caitlin's getting dropped on her head repeatedly.
Yeah, kick out at two.
She didn't hook the legs. Kaitlyn couldn't even get her legs up. She barely got that arm up. And let me hold on for a second. Let's see what I got down here.
You drank it all. What are you doing?
Do they serve at the concession stand anymore?
They don't serve alcohol, no.
What a wrestling show is this? It's like going to a hockey game and only being able to eat the wiener, you know what I'm saying?
No, I don't know what you're saying.
You ever eat a hot dog?
Yeah, but...
At a hockey game?
Yes. Here's a cover. I'm not going to try to figure out what the hell you're talking about.
Yeah, I guess. You know, this match has been going on for quite a while. These girls have got some... Just trying to muscle her up.
Oh.
I mean, that would be a feat. Kaitlyn's a...
She brought her up.
Oh, the pounce! Pounces her to the floor.
Here we go.
Again, oh, Kaitlyn Marie. Kaitlyn Marie's cranking up again. Here she comes.
Oh, hard clothesline. Look at how much aggression's on Kaitlyn's face. Oh, beautiful duck. Oh.
Stunner.
Oh, wow. She's like out on her feet, staggering the rope.
Yeah, she's hanging. Leah Knight's hanging
and
over the second rope.
And this is no man's land with Kaitlyn Marie.
Oh! Choking her on that second rope.
Kaitlyn's hitting all her hits tonight. I think we're about ready to see the end. Oh! Vader bomb coming up in five.
She's
four,
going up.
Three, two, one.
And that's going to do it, most probably. Well, she's not going for the cover.
Oh, I think Kaitlyn's gonna kind of having a mean streak here.
She's got a little more punishment in mind here.
This waiting crowd on, solidly behind her. Solid behind
to get to her feet.
Oh, Sting! Did you hear that?
And that's gonna do it. Oh,
whoa.
No! Oh my God!
Oh, but Kaitlyn scoots in. She's going for the rear naked choke, but she's got the body triangle on. With that body triangle, there's nowhere for Leah Night to go.
This is an impressive submission.
Hell yeah, this is one of the best showings she's ever had. Look at this, she pulls her back, just out of desperation, trying to get the pin.
Leah Night able to get out of it.
I was surprised by that.
Yeah, she had that body triangle
on so tight.
Yeah, she had it sunk tight. Now Knight back in the...
These girls are about spent.
Yeah, they've been going a mile a minute since
the match
started.
Yeah, Leah's been working on that arm the entire match. She might have just found the Achilles heel here on Kaitlyn Marie. What an impressive showing by both these women.
Oh!
But she held on. Look at that. She's going for the Kimura. This has got to be it. Kaitlyn has nowhere to go.
Kaitlyn's going to have to tap out here.
Oh, wow. What perfect positioning, lateral press here.
Leah could break her arm easily in this position.
Wow, Kimura with the lateral press. Look, Kaitlyn has no. She's reaching. Just reaching. Could she get it?
She's almost there.
She got it. Wow. What hard determination by Kaitlyn.
Knight won't let it go. She did. She did release the hold. But you got to think what damage has been done to Kaitlyn Marie's arm.
I mean, wow. I mean, when's the last time you saw someone put a Kimura on in a wrestling ring? And then with a body lock on them with the leverage.
Yeah,
I mean, just incredible. Deep. Oh, wow. Backhanded chop to the face.
Oh,
rolling bomb. She pulls her over.
And here's a cover. Oh,
she rolls her back over. She's going for it again.
Oh, she's back into the rear naked choke. And she's locked in.
Leah Night, can she find the escape hatch again? She can find the escape trap door. No,
she doesn't.
She taps out.
She had her rolled over on the side.
Kaitlyn Marie.
What a battle. She had her rolled over on the side, so she couldn't use the same escape. And got the tap out. And Kaitlyn Marie with the win by submission over Leah Night.
Tonight, Mason Allen, the prodigy, the blue chipper, the future of wrestling, finally gets his opportunity against Tommy Okami's Legacy Championship.
Not only is this my shot for Tommy's Legacy Championship, but buddy, this is Tommy's shot to prove to me he even deserves to be close to that championship. See, I'm the man. This is what I do. I go out on Wrestling Evolution on a weekly, daily, minutely basis, and I continue to win and get better and better and better. And Tommy, he's just staying right there. That's what he does. This is what I do. So tonight, Wrestling Evolution sees the mountaintop. They see the limit get even further, extended further, because it doesn't get any better.
Very confident. You heard it there from Mason Allen. Back to you.
Introducing team number one from the highest parts of Amish country, Betsy the Chicken, their companion, total combined weight of 555 pounds. This is Amish Country.
All right, here comes Amish Country. They are definitely a different kind of tag team, making their way to the ring with a live chicken
and a butter churn. I'm not quite sure how to describe these guys. They're, like I said, they're a different team. And you hear the chants of KFC coming from the crowd, and these buckets, I'm not sure where these buckets are coming from. Everybody seems to, I guess they went by KFC before they came to the show. The Amish country making their way around. They don't seem real happy with the chants of KFC. There you see Betsy the Chicken being secured in her basket and thankfully being taken back to the backstage area. Not exactly a place for livestock out in the ring, but there you see Amish country set for tag team action. And here are their opponents, and again, another unorthodox
team. Introducing their opponents, total combined weight 425 pounds, all the way from Bedrock, North Carolina, Yabba Dabba Doody and Foshi.
Yabba Dabba Daddy and Foshi. Here they come. What? Oh, he's got a surprise for us. Oh, my God. Okay, as if this could not.
And introducing Alex the Dinosaur.
If this couldn't get any weirder, now we've got a dinosaur out here with Yabba Dabba Daddy and Foshi. Alex. Alex the Dinosaur out here at ringside. This is going to be weird. That's the only way I can say. Yabba Dabba Daddy, straight from from Bedrock.
We got this, Alex. Yeah.
I thought the Flintstones dinosaur was named Dino. But anyway, here we are. We're set for action. Tag team action. Foshi and Yabba Dabba Daddy against Jebediah and Hezekiah Hoskins, Amish country. At least the chicken is gone from ringside, but I guess the dinosaur is staying. I don't know. Hezekiah offering to check the beard there to make sure nothing was no foreign object was stowed in the beard. Here we go now. Yabba Dabba Daddy and Hezekiah Hoskins starting out this match. Nice side headlock from Hoskins. And these guys are definitely unorthodox. We've said that, we talked about this before with Amish country. Now this is a new little wrinkle here with apparently prehistoric people coming in as well in animal skins. And Foshi, I'm not sure how he fits into the dinosaur motif. But Amish country, like I said, unorthodox team, but definitely effective. You can see a little bit of chain wrestling between these two. Kind of a dead heat here between Hezekiah and Yabba Dabba Daddy. Now a double drop kick and a standoff. Now there's a tag to Foshi. Yabba Dabba Daddy still in the ring though. Oh, now is Foshi and Hezekiah. And again, Yabba Dabba Daddy inside the ring. Referee Josh Diamond giving a little leeway here, I guess. A little too much, I think. Now he's out of the ring, and there's a cover. But only getting a two count. Yabba Dabba Daddy back in his corner over there with Alex the Dinosaur. And a reversal by Foshi on Hezekiah. And a takeover. Hezekiah was headed to the wrong ring. And paying for it back there in the corner of Yabba Dabba Daddy and Foshi. Another tag. Cheered on by Alex the Dinosaur. This is the weird. That's the weirdest thing I think I've ever said. Now, Hezekiah. Oh, nice suplex. Northern Light suplex and a cover. But Hezekiah kicking out before the three count. You hear Jebediah from the corner complaining about the chance of KFC, but I don't think that's really going to stop anything. Crowd really enjoys talking about KFC when it comes to Betsy the Chicken. Again, quick tag between Yabba Dabba Daddy and Foshi. Foshi up to the top rope. There's not a lot of clearance up there, better watch out. Oh, Hezekiah with a quick rake of the eyes. Taking control of Foshi, sending him back into the corner of Amish country. But Foshi met him with an elbow as he came in, but a grab of the ponytail by Jebediah takes him down in their corner, and he's definitely in the wrong side of the ring. Not a good neighborhood. Being choked on the second rope. Josh Diamond administering the count, getting Hezekiah off of him, but now with Hezekiah keeping his attention, Jebediah is taking advantage here. And the Huskies just switched around, but I don't think I saw a tag there. Jebediah's big size 12 boot right on the chest of Foshi, and again, in the wrong part of town, Foshi stuck over there with Hezekiah. And these two are moving in and out of the ring. Haven't seen a tag here lately. Josh Diamond now with his attention back over here. Hezekiah choking Foshi in their corner. And again, Josh Diamond's attention being pulled away, and the Hoskins taking advantage of that. Again, no tag, moving back in. Applying the pressure on Foshi, keeping him cut off from their corner. You can see Alex the Dinosaur cheering everybody on here. Hoskins still with the pressure on Foshi, holding in that sleeper hold. Elbows to the midsection as Foshi tries to make his way back up off the ropes. Oh, met with a spine buster from Hoskins and a choke. Hoskins choking Foshi. He's been in the ring for a while now. He needs to make a tag. He needs to get over to his corner, but the Huskies are doing a great job keeping him separated. Bringing him out of the corner straight into a low drop kick, and here's a cover. Only a two count. Hezekiah right on top of Josh Diamond, claiming a slow count. Bringing Foshi back up. Nice leg kick from Foshi, trying to get his way out of this predicament and get himself back over to make a tag to his partner. Oh, knee. High knee to Hezekiah. Takes him down. Now both men are down in the ring. Both men need to get to their corner to make a tag. You can see Hezekiah trying to stop Foshi. He's got his leg. But Inseguri clears the way to get to Yabba Dabba Daddy now. Yabba Daddy, Dabba Daddy, sorry, it's hard to say, in the ring, cleaning out the Hoskins. Back in the corner on Hezekiah. Shoots him across and follows him in. Nice running European uppercut. But Hezekiah slips off. Now off the ropes. Nice sling blade takes him down. If there's anything that the Hoskins should know about, it would be the a sling blade. Now Foshi out of the corner with a back spring cutter. Now, both the Hoskins are outside the ring, out there with Alex the Dinosaur. Hoskins trying to collect himself. Foshi's gathering. I don't know what he's got planned. Oh, he stopped. And now just taunting Hoskins outside. I'm not sure what's going on here. They're just kind of hanging out, giving the Hoskins the time to recover. But now, but Dabba Dabba Daddy outside on to Hezekiah. Trying to get Hezekiah back up to his feet. You got to get him back in the ring because that's where the match has to end. Now here comes Foshi over the top on the Jebediah, taking him out on the ringside area. Sliding him back into the ring. Now the Hoskins are both inside. Foshi, again, going to the top rope. There's not a lot of clear. Both Jebediah Daddy and Foshi off the top rope with frog slashes. A double cover, but both of them only a two count. And at this point, I have no clue who the legal man is. This has kind of gotten out of control. Now all four men fighting in the inside the ring. The Hoskins back in the corners. Now, Foshi and both of them coming in, and both of them getting met as they came in. Now, Foshi's out to the outside. Yabba Dabba Daddy ducked the clothesline, but now the Hoskins take him out, and here's a cover. But he got his shoulder up. He got his shoulder up, I think. Jebediah is absolutely shocked that he was able to do that. Now he's setting him up for a pile driver. Oh, okay. Now that's got to be it. Yabba Dabba Daddy is out. And the Hoskins get the cover. Jebediah gets the cover and the win.
Amish Country.
Amish Country definitely stating a claim for whoever wins the tag team championship tonight, making a case that they should be in the run for one of their first title defenses. All right, here comes John Matthews.
You know what? I think we've seen this movie before, and we've seen it again, and we've seen the sequel. This is like Halloween 6 right here, okay? It's not that good. You know, I know that John wants to be a wrestler, okay? And I know that the crowd seems to like this goofy individual. However, he's a loser, okay?
Oh, wow, that's harsh.
Well, hold on a second. I mean, he has the worst win-loss record. Pretty much all losses here at Wrestling Evolution.
Well, yeah, I will say that.
You know, he's a security guy. Okay, his job is to be the security guy, and he keeps finagling his way into matches, you know, at the behest of the owner of the company. Look, there he is, the CEO security right there, you know.
Yep, he's wearing the shirt. I guess he's still on duty.
Yes! Yes, he is!
So he's
So he's still on duty. So
really? Really, he's on duty? So if there's some vigilante in the parking lot ready to shoot this place up or blow up the building, where is our personal security?
And here comes his opponent, Peterbilt.
You know, I've never been a Peterbilt fan, okay? I think he's just a jacked up imbecile, you know, muscle bound goof. But you know what? I kind of might enjoy watching Peterbilt sling around old John Matthews.
He's in extra jack.
Extra good shape. I mean, look at that.
Look at that.
Look at that.
The body on Peterbilt.
I mean, the women love Peter because he's built, if you know what I mean.
Smell what I'm cooking. Ah, there he goes.
I mean, have you ever even seen one of your abs there, Tim?
I've heard rumor that they're there.
Just one, huh? Just one, big one.
Yep, one big one.
One big one. Oh,
Peterbilt's getting the mic.
Real quick, first off, it's been a good little while. How's everybody doing? Man, I heard you on the, Eager Beaver, I heard you on the other end of the locker room the whole night, man, when I'm putting on my boots and stuff, just yapping. So, if you want to run with the big dogs, buddy, try to stay on the porch, okay?
Oh,
all right.
Oh. You know, I kind of like this attitude by Peter, you know? I mean...
Well, yeah,
I mean, that...
I guess you may not be the only one that's tired of this experiment.
I mean, come on. Matthews is he's continuously losing, okay? If I'm Peterbilt and I'm standing there across the ring from somebody like this that and be like, why are they putting me in here with this guy, you know? I mean, this would be just a wrestling lesson right here, you know? This might be just a night off for Peter. Look at the strength of Bill.
Oh, he's not wasting any time.
No, he's not.
And Peterbilt waiting on Matthews to get up.
And look at Matthews. He's already in there struggling, and Peter's not even breathing heavy.
There's a look on Peterbilt's face tonight.
Well, he's a superb athlete here. I mean, come on. I mean, who's in better shape than Peterbilt?
Nobody.
The champion, Don Fury. Oh, wow, look at the form on that. Oh, wow. Rake in the shoulder. I'm starting to like this.
Peterbilt's extra aggressive tonight.
Extra aggressive. Look at that. Fireman's carryover keeps the hand. Wow.
Wow, this is impressive. And, he's
playing to the hard count.
Yeah, absolutely. We love that.
Yeah.
And it's almost like he might be trying to teach a lesson here.
Well, I think he might be partially insulted. I mean, Peterbilt, you know, he's wrestled and competed for the Legacy Championship. Unfortunately, he came up short. I mean, just because you came up short doesn't mean you got to go, wrestle the guy with the worst record.
John Matthews just said it's his turn.
His turn. Oh, beautiful float over, but Peter catches him.
Oh, boy.
Oh, no.
Oh,
wow, Mason slips out. Wow.
Matthews slips out.
Over. Rolls him over.
Didn't quite get that locked in there. Oh, boy.
Oh,
wow.
I don't know if that was a good idea. Slapping the starch out of Peter ain't gonna win you any friends.
Oh,
beautiful crossbody.
That was impressive.
You know, you gotta give a little credit to Matthews for having some gumption here, but let's get back to reality here. He's in there with the best athlete in the building. Reversal by Bill using that strength. Oh,
right into a clothesline.
What a superb athlete Bill is.
Yeah, Peterbilt getting cranked up here. Planting Matthews.
Who is
down.
Stronger than Bill?
And look at
Jesus.
This.
Oh, wow.
Look at this athleticism. We talk about how strong he is, but then you get an example like that of his athleticism is impressive.
I mean, but any time, I mean, Peterbilt could be the champion. He could be the legacy champion. He could be the heavyweight champion. And then, but Matthews has no chance of even smelling the bag with the belts in. Man, Peter's, that was stiff. But
ouch.
Man, but Peter is jacked up. Now, how would you describe Matthew's physique? Skip cardio, maybe? High carb diet? Oh, wow.
But he has Peterbilt back in the corner. Maybe,
No, don't even say it.
Dusty Rhodes-esque.
I was going to say, if you say that Peterbilt, took Matthews lightly, you would be wrong. This is a superb athlete here.
I was still trying to come up with a description for Matthews' physique.
Yeah. I mean, Matthews, I'll give him credit. He's keeping it competitive here.
Yep.
I mean, he's using his weight to his advantage. I mean, it might not be the most ripped up or chiseled. Oh, look at that.
And we're kind of talking lightly about it, but that is a good point. Dusty Rhodes was never the best physical specimen.
Wait a minute. Hold on for a second.
I am hold not on a saying.
Second. You are comparing Matthews to the legendary great NWA Hall of Fame champion Dusty Rhodes. Oh, come on,
I
Tim.
Am not saying
come
that
on.
He is Dusty
Get the
Rhodes.
Hell out of here.
I am saying that Dusty Rhodes was not exactly the greatest example of physical fitness.
Yeah. That's saying it lightly.
Oh! Nice suplex!
But he was also a multi-time world champion.
Yes. So now it is possible to be both.
Yeah, yeah. Okay, so how many championships have Matthews won?
None, as far as
okay.
I know.
How many matches has he won here?
One, I believe.
Okay, and before this, how many matches has he won? I looked it up, 4. So, and we're talking about regional talent, like bottom of the barrel, APW Spartanburg. He's got a win over Jay Eagle now.
Oh.
Yeah. And I love old Jerry Bragg.
I love
oh!
it.
Oh!
Big
enough
sharp
playing
close
around.
Line.
Oh! Yeah!
He's swinging the heavy lumber now.
Swinging heavy lumber. I mean, nobody swings harder than Bilt does. Look at that power slam. What delivery!
That'll do it.
And by.
No! Matthew's got his shoulder up.
Man, he slung Matthew so hard in the turnbuckle. He just bounced out. What a textbook power slam.
I am shocked.
I am pretty shocked. Bilt lifts him up. Look at the strength.
Oh, Matthew's got out of it again.
Goes for a reverse ripcord flatliner. Hooks the leg.
Oh.
Whoa.
He real got it up.
That was quick.
Matthews trying to gain some momentum here.
Yeah, I mean, imagine how Matthews must be feeling. I mean, he's constantly losing matches here. You know, and he's in there with the best athlete in there. I mean, he's got to understand that he's got everything against him.
Oh, here he comes.
Oh, but lands on his feet, rolls through, waiting on Bilt. Oh, Bilt catches him. And I just honestly be honest about something. I think Bilt is pissed off.
Oh,
I
yeah.
think we're about ready to end this experiment right now. Good night. Party's
That'll
over.
That'll do it.
Later.
Yep.
Peterbilt, another win.
Nobody's kicking out of that.
Hell no, they're not. Matthews tried to make it competitive, but I think he just poked the bear, and Bilt just finished him.
Oh.
Whoa.
Uh-oh.
Whoa.
The boss.
Here comes the boss. Now, if I was Tim Wilcox, I would come right out here and you know, advance the pay of Peterbilt. What a performance.
Here he comes. So we see what's going to happen now.
He doesn't look happy.
He never looks happy. What are you talking about?
Look, Bilt's getting out of the way, out of the ring. I mean,
I don't blame him.
No, he's got nothing else to prove. He's got nothing else to prove.
All right, Wilcox getting in the ring with his employee, John Matthews.
Yeah, employee. Just remember that. Employee.
Oh, boy.
You know, and Wilcox is in better shape than Matthews ever could dream. Should dump that water on Matthews' head.
He just dropped it in the ring.
Matthews. You have got to be, by far, the worst talent on the Wrestling Evolution roster.
Preach on, Brother Wilcox. Preach on.
The best thing for you to do, you're supposed to be my CEO, head of security, and you want to have these aspirations of being a professional wrestler.
Another security guard getting in the ring.
Well, hold on. He's also a security guard.
Puck! You suck!
Why is
You're by far the worst wrestler I've ever seen! I would put on somebody else out of this crowd than you in here and get better entertainment!
Oh, he's gonna talk.
I didn't give you permission!
Don't even let him
speak! Get the mic either!
He never does.
Listen up! Next month, March 16th, breaking rules! we're going to have an evaluation of you in the middle of this ring, and I'm going to depend upon that as to whether or not you still have a job here, punk. Got it.
Employee review. Oh, boy.
Now, get out my ring, get your shirt on, and do what you're supposed to do.
Well, I've never had an employee review under these kind of conditions.
I do not want one anyway. Why would you want one? Look at... Wow, this crowd is all over Wilcox. Why are they booing the boss? I mean...
I don't know. Well, I mean, I got some ideas, but... But, yeah, next month we're going to have...
You hear that? The you suck chants going on. I think that's for Matthews.
I don't think so. All right, so coming up next month, we're going to have an employee review for...
Oh, we get the light show again. Go ahead and say it. Yeah. Go ahead and say it. Go ahead and say it.
Here comes the boss. Well, actually, there goes
there the boss. There goes the boss. Yeah. Now go ahead and say it. Go ahead and say it. What, next month?
So next month, yeah, we're going to have an employee review of John Matthews to see if he keeps his job. Now, is it which job is it, though? Is it CEO security?
Or
is
it a wrestler? I just fire his ass, period.
Just straight out everything? Okay.
Useless. Garbage.
All right, well, that's coming up next month. Well, here we are, ready for championship action. The Legacy Championship is on the line. And here comes Mason Allen.
And also, in tow, Justin Kindred. Now, look, let me just cut you off, Tim. If there's one man that has risen to the occasion here at Wrestling Evolution, it is Mason Allen.
I completely agree with you. He is undefeated here in Wrestling Evolution.
Taking on all comers and put them to bed.
Absolutely.
Including your buddy, John Skyler.
17-year veteran.
Well, that 17 years didn't really help him against Mason Allen. And listen, he's also, you know, he is also the leader, you know, the blue chipper. You know, the future of the whole Allen clan. I mean.
Yeah, the rest of the Allen clan doesn't seem like they want to have a whole lot to do with him, though.
Why not? I mean, look, what, this guy just keeps on winning. Why wouldn't you want to be around a winner?
I don't know. You know how brothers are. And so now we'll toss it back to our backstage interviewer, Sammy, with a word with Tommy Okami.
Thanks, Tim. This is Tommy Okami, who's facing the undefeated Mason Allen tonight momentarily.
The next time Mason Allen's name comes out of your mouth, it's going to be the newly defeated Mason Allen. Before this, I've been doing it for my loves. Tonight, it's about me and him.
And his opponent. He is the Wrestling Evolution Legacy Champion, the Enchanting One, Tommy Okami!
Well, you know, Tim, Tommy Okami seemed extremely focused. He didn't play no games. He didn't even try to hit on old Sammy.
No, he's ready to go.
Oh, he's ready to go here.
Ready to defend his Legacy Championship.
But let's be honest about something, man. This might be the biggest test of Tommy Okami's career.
I think absolutely.
I mean, if there's anyone that should be confident, it is Mason Allen.
Yeah, Mason Allen riding a great wave of momentum into this match. Saw the little dust up between them last month.
Oh, and Justin Kindred has him primed, baby.
Yeah, Tommy up in the face of Mason Allen. And Justin's holding him back.
Hey, look, Mason's ready to go. Mason's ready to go. Maybe Tommy Okami so does covet that Legacy Championship. But then again, Mason Allen is undefeated.
Tommy Okami winning the
Legacy Championship from Myrick Moore, who was the first Legacy Champion here in Wrestling Evolution.
You know, and Myrick Moore is no slouch. So
absolutely not.
Yeah, so when Mason Allen dethrones Tommy, right, that means that he's also beaten every man that came before him. Look how relaxed Mason looks. I mean, he's not even letting the pressure of being in there for a championship even affect him.
This is going to be a great match. Two of the incredible young talent here in Wrestling Evolution.
And I don't, you know, yes, and I don't think Tommy is, I don't think he really likes Kindred being out here. He's not playing games like normal. He's not working, you know, yep. The you know, pan it. Well,
here's a little panel.
Little panel. You know, some people, they go out there and they kind of thrive on that crowd adulation. Mason does it, and he continues the win.
Yep.
Mason, that might be a strength.
The thing that Mason thrives on, winning. Just got deposited back in the corner by Tommy Okami, and Tommy looks relaxed too.
He looks. They, the guys both look very, very relaxed. I mean, they're both very successful. But again, Okami is not undefeated. Mason is. Look at that beautiful waist lock.
Shoving Okami over into the ropes.
But this is Mason. Firmly believe this is his time.
Oh yeah. I have never seen Mason more confident. Now, Kami.
Wow, that's beautiful headlock takeover.
Oh, but
beautiful head scissors. I mean, these guys are very well versed. Okami has actually got some size on Mason, but I don't think Mason really gives a damn.
Right into that headlock again.
Oh, these guys are going to have to keep it basic. I mean, these guys aren't stupid. They know what's on the line. Wow, beautiful top wrist lock. Reverses into a headlock of his own. Mason is no slouch out there.
Tommy with him, shooting him off in the ropes.
Oh, what a shoulder block.
Big shoulder block takes Okami down.
Takes him down, more like runs him down. And now Mason's starting to pick up the pace.
The leapfrog.
Mason stops him. Okami, wow, this might be a chess match.
Couple reversals and now into a cover.
You're not going to make Mason go into the night that easily. Wow. Whoa, look at that. He went for an arm drag, but Okami had it well scouted. He's definitely done his homework on Mason Allen.
Nice. And he's controlling the arm of Mason Allen. That was actually very impressive.
Very impressive. Hey, Okami's always evolving and stuff, but I mean, Mason's just evolved at a faster pace. It's just we're gonna have to see who can run the fastest and last the longest. Oh,
shots to the midsection.
Look at that headbutt to the shoulder to break it. Wow! Japanese arm drag by Okami. Always evolving. Mason scoots into the corner. Look at the welt on Mason's back. Wow.
And Justin Kindred over in the corner. Words of wisdom, I guess, maybe.
Words of wisdom. It's called support. Wow.
Tommy just firing shots.
Yeah, he's getting more and more aggressive lately. You know, usually Okami doesn't jawjack with the ref out there, but I mean, again, this is what's on the line.
It was hard for me to see. Was that a headbutt?
It was. It was a forearm head. And oh, Okami answers one of his own.
Now Mason just hanging on the turnbuckle.
You know, they talk about wow. Monkey flip.
Holy crap.
He almost hit us.
He almost ended up in our laps.
Incredible. And this crowd explodes. Cover.
The height on that and the distance on that monkey flip is impressive.
What leg strength that must took by Okami.
Oh, wow.
Okami double drop kick. Wow. Mason scoots out. You know, you talk about championships here. And people talk about Don Fear and his ascension to the heavyweight championship.
Sure, yep.
But let's talk about something that people don't really consider. The legacy champion. You have to become the legacy champion normally to even get a sniff of the heavyweight championship. And Kindred definitely helping out Mason. But being the legacy champion, you got to face all comers. The unknowns, the young lions. I mean, it's a grueling task.
And Tommy Okami got to the legacy championship through a series of like multiple man matches. So he has faced a lot of competitors.
Yeah, exactly. So the legacy title,
just might be even harder to attain, but even harder to retain. Look at that.
Up.
Wow, Samoan drop.
Samoan drop by Okami.
This is not going in Mason's favor so far.
Yeah, Tommy, Okami and seemingly in control of this match.
We have 30 minutes, though, Tim. We have a 30-minute time limit. This is far from over.
Yeah, this could end up being a long, grueling match.
I'm so excited about this. I mean, he went the limit and just literally dispatched of John Skyler. So Mason can go. He's been in trouble before, and he's pulled it through. Do you think he could pull it again, Tim? Oh, wow, he's going for a pump handle. Look at Mason.
Mason slipped out of it.
Look at that.
Oh. Met him right on the ropes.
Incredible. Incredible. All that punishment Okami gave him. Mason pulls through.
Mason needs to stay on task. Keep on Okami.
This crowd behind Okami. Again, Mason doesn't give a damn.
Oh, the knee right to the center of the back.
Oh, Mason's a student of the game. I mean, we're talking about Okami earlier with those Japanese arm drags.
Yeah.
Mason knows exactly what he's doing.
You know what he's doing? Playing to the hard cam.
He's playing to the hard cam.
Love it. Love it.
Even in this uber tense moment where everything's on the line, still playing to the hard cam. I mean, look at the welts on Okami. These guys are getting physical. We're only a few minutes into this. Wow, that was a stiff uppercut.
Yeah, neither one of these guys is going to hold back at all.
Oh!
Okami off the second rope, but he meets a boot.
Oh!
And a DDT from Mason.
Look at Mason. He's almost relishing these people, booing them. He wants to prove everybody wrong. He's done it before. Can he do it again?
Unable to get a three count on this one. Very close, though.
Well, Okami, I mean, he's been in these multiple matches where you got to have your eyes in the back of your head, and there's bodies flying out everywhere. I mean, he wasn't taken down before. It's going to take a lot for Mason to get the job done, but I think he can do it.
There's another cover.
Wow, that was close. You know, I got to say, this is the best version we've ever seen of Mason. We talk about him with Skyler, but he's even performing better.
He seems more confident. He, like I said, I've never seen him more confident. And he's aggressive. With each win, he's gaining more of that.
That's right.
And you have to when you're undefeated. How else are you not going to gain confidence?
Exactly. He's not rushing anything. He's doing a great job.
He's coming into his own.
Exactly.
More and more.
He's just waiting in the wings for Okami.
Stalking.
He went for the bow.
He went for the backstabber.
Okami was close to the rope, though. Oh, here we go.
Line.
Oh, wow, Okami's starting to speed it up.
Yeah, momentum switching back and forth between these two men the entire
time. Scoops him up. Wow, look at that. Oh, but picks up Mason's head. Did you see that?
Yep.
He did not let him rest. He did not let him lie.
Okami off the ropes.
Oh, holy
cow. He rolled through.
Wow.
Mason rolled through.
Wow, did you just see that? Incredible.
What an impressive move.
What an impressive match. This match is quickly stealing the show.
And now Okami has reversed it again. Oh, look at he's biting him.
He's biting him.
Good Lord. Again, an example of what these guys are willing to do to win this Legacy Championship.
I think Mason will do just about anything.
Yeah.
But Okami, he's starting to show kind of a mean streak. He's going to have to get a lot nastier to dispatch of the challenger.
These guys.
Oh my God!
Oh,
oh my God! That was absolutely incredible.
Innovative
Mason,
offense.
What a stud! What a stud! Can he turn him over and get it done? Come on, Mason! Cover!
Cover!
Wow!
Oh!
This crowd thought that was over.
They did. They were counting along, but Tommy Okami is not done yet.
What a match! You know, this is what we're talking about. Which everybody talks about the independent wrestling scene and such like that. Just making your way. This is the future of wrestling. When I talk about the future of wrestling, and I talk about Mason Allen, I 100% believe it, Tim.
I can see that.
Tommy Okami ain't no slouch either. This is the future, every way you look at it. Only the best.
Oh, dragging his forehead across that top rope.
I mean, these guys have hit each other with impact moves, submission moves. They're using the ring. I mean, They're pretty much swinging for the fences. Anything goes.
Yeah, from the beginning of this match, they have been
and
swinging
even things,
for the fences.
Yeah, and even things like this where Mace is just talking junk. I mean, there's a strategy to everything going on here. This is like a masterclass.
That is one thing with Mason Allen. There's always a strategy. He's always got a plan.
Wow, huge knee lift.
Big high knee from Tommy Okami.
This is, Tim, this is incredible. This is like the match of the night so far. And who is going to top this?
And Okami, can Okami take advantage of it? He looks a little woozy.
And with what's at stake, I mean, this is just incredible. Here comes Okami.
Oh, Mason moved.
Oh, wow.
And here's a cover.
Wow, Mason just fell on him.
In desperation.
Yeah, Okami's kickouts are coming slow.
Yeah, you
what
can see.
What a match.
See Tommy Okami's eyes.
You know, a lot of people talk about Okami, you know, and the lover and all that other stuff. You know, I kind of give him a razzle. Oh! But, hey, he's stepping up to the plate, too. I think these guys have something to prove to each other and to themselves, and they're showing it all out there.
Trading shots in the center of the ring.
Oh, my God. Oh, my God, Tim. Can you believe this?
It's a standoff right in the center of the ring. Now Mason back on the ropes. Okami sending him over.
What gut check. What gut check by both men.
Oh, oh, right across the knee.
Here comes the flatliner.
Oh.
No, he cut it with a clothesline. That's usually the setup for the flatliner.
Again.
Do you think Okami just didn't have the gas tank?
I think, yeah, Okami draped across the ropes. He has to be running
wow,
short.
Just, look at both men. I mean, this has been one hell of a contest, Tim. This is everything we expected.
Tommy's he's going for his finish. That elbow. Wait a minute, Justin.
Oh, here's
Kindred. Oh! Kindred knocked off of the ring apron.
Look at that. Here we go. Oh. Spine buster of his own, Okami. Wow, Okami's
going for it again.
He's going for it again.
Away from Kindred this time.
But Mason
moved
ready.
Out of the way.
Mason had that move well scouted.
All right, now Kindred.
Mason's got to get up. He's got to take advantage. This is his opportunity. I know he's hurt. I know he's tired. But, you know, this is his chance.
Mason trying to make his way to his feet. Okami hanging on the ropes over there. And Justin Kindred over on that side. You got to keep aware of where he is.
Oh. He's got him on his shoulders.
Okami's got him up. But Mason's sliding out.
Oh, my God. Did you see that? The referee saw none of it.
Kindred just hit him with the boot.
It's happening. It happened.
That was it.
Mason did it. And I think he even won some of these crowds over. Look at this. He did it.
Mason did it with the help of Justin Kindred at his boot.
Legacy champion.
Mason did it. Go into it. Give him the honor. Go in and announce him. Come on, Tim. You know it's true.
The new legacy champion is Mason Allen, thanks to a one-shoe-wearing Justin Kindred in the ring.
That's right. Beautiful. Absolutely beautiful. Outstanding job by Mason.
The undefeated streak continues for Mason Allen.
Yeah, the legacy champion,
and he is the new legacy champion.
It was almost like the numbers game eventually just got to Okami.
Well, of course, yeah.
I think there's going to be a celebration in Poundtown tonight. What do you think?
Maybe in Allentown.
Maybe in Allentown.
Because there's a chance that the Allens could come out of here, all the Allens could come out of here with gold.
Be serious, Tim. Come on.
I am serious. In our main event.
You're going to sit there and talk about the Allen brothers and just over. Wait a minute.
Tommy
Okami. He's really mad.
He's up in the face of Justin Diamond.
Oh, he's upset. I mean, the referee didn't see it. This is how the numbers game works.
Okami, that's a little scary. Tommy
yeah,
seems to be losing.
He's
extremely upset about losing his legacy championship. And he's taking it out on Justin Diamond. Which you can't really blame him because he was hit in the face with Justin Kindred's boot.
He just said the referee screwed him over.
Yep.
He is not happy. Oh, that's going to be a long, cold shower in the locker room.
Yep.
But let's take nothing away from the performance by both men. However, again, the winner and new legacy champion, and I'm so damn proud. And didn't I call it
Mason
Allen?
And here comes Dontay Khalifah.
Coming to us from Charlotte, North Carolina. He is the Ascension contract winner. He is the Dontay Khalifah.
Hey, if there's a threat to the heavyweight championship, I mean, I know Ken Magnum has been slotted for the, you know, for the semi-main event tonight.
Yeah.
But let's be honest. I mean, Dontay Khalifah is waiting in the wings for whoever has that championship.
Absolutely. The owner of the Ascension contract.
Oh, and he is so damn good.
He's always waiting in the weeds, biding his time to see when he can cash in that championship. And here comes his opponent, Diego Hill.
You know, and Dontay took this match with Diego Hill without reservation. In fact, I think we got some words from him earlier. Let's take it there at this time.
Wrestling Evolution. Let me introduce you to myself. I'm Diego Hill, the top North Carolina talent around here. And got this match against Dontay Khalifah. And I hear all this talking he's been doing, but guess what? I ain't with all that talking. Actions speak louder than words, baby boy.
And introducing his opponent from Virginia Beach, Virginia, weighing in at 183 pounds, he is the Dive Bomb, Diego Hill.
Wow.
Yeah, definitely a mixed reaction.
I mean, Dontay Khalifah, he's continuously evolving. You can't help but be impressed by him.
Diego Hill making his way around around the ring. This should be an incredible match.
Well, these guys are both very fast and very athletic. Look at that.
Into the ring. Wow.
Wow, right up in Dante's face. You don't see that often.
And I don't think Dontay likes it.
These guys are very evenly matched physically, but, you know, Dontay Khalifah is just ripped to shreds, and he's got more muscle mass. I mean, look at the shoulders on Dontay.
Yeah.
I mean, what do you think he eats? Just cans of tuna, celery, and maybe a boiled egg? Nothing. When's the last time you've ate any of those?
I like tuna salad.
How much dressing you put on that?
Well, you got to make it taste good.
Oh, a bona fide mean streak on Dontay.
Oh, you know that.
You know that.
All right. Khalifah and Hill getting ready to tie it up in the center of the ring. All right. Circling in the center. Oh, boy. God, the quickness of Diego Hill.
Dante's a fast guy too, man.
Oh yeah, I'm not saying he isn't, but
what's all this fandom here of the speed? Really? Because I just saw Dontay Khalifah blur the lines right there.
I want to break it. Dontay claims he's gonna break the arm of.
But Dante's got
Diego.
Such a mean streak. I mean, really you'd be surprised.
Yeah. You need to. Oh wow. Oh. Hill just stepping on the back of Dontay Khalifah.
Well, you keep doing stuff, you're going to piss Dontay off. It's true.
That's not something you want to do.
No, you don't. I took his parking spot one time.
Oh, boy. Yeah, you don't want that.
No, I did not enjoy that. It was an awful day for me. I was wondering where my girlfriend was that night.
Oh, Dontay stalking up behind him. Yeah, we don't need to hear that story.
I'd like to forget. She was never quite the same, if you get my drift.
Oh, boy.
Dontay with a beautiful headlock. I mean, he's just so crisp, and so fast, and so technically sound.
Whoa! Diego just bounced right up from that.
Wow.
Oh!
There we go!
Jeez.
Again, these guys are very evenly matched. Wow, I mean, they're not just colliding in the ring. Now they're just throwing. Look at that.
Whoa! Holy crap!
Look at Dante's face! Dante rolls through. I mean, these guys are, oh! You know, it's almost like Diego Hill is like trying to get something going, but Dante keeps stopping him. Whoever he was successful at throwing him over that time, right to the breadbasket. Beautiful kick.
Jeez.
Nice sweep. Back drop. Oh, no.
The rapid fire offense from Diego Hill. Now, you have to say, this is going to be interesting. Here's a cover. It's going to be interesting to see how Dante adapts to this style. This is not Dante's style.
Well, I mean, hold on for a second. Dante is usually the fastest guy in the ring.
And he's being outmatched on the speed
side. Hold on. I don't know what are you watching here. Okay, so they match up very equally with speed, okay? Wait till Dante gets going, okay?
And that's what I'm saying. It'll be interesting to see how Dante gets through this match.
Oh, wow, look at that.
Wow. Oh, my God.
Dante just collapsed like a tree trunk. Look, just hanging on the bottom rope.
He's making his way back up. Pulling himself up by the turnbuckle.
You know, Diego Hill's kind of an unknown to a lot of the guys here. You know, maybe, I hate to say this, Dante might have took him lightly. But then
here
again, Diego might be taking Dante lightly.
Yep.
Look at that.
Whoa.
Oh!
Dante caught him, sent him back into the turnbuckle.
All that flash. And then at one moment, Dante just cuts him off. Oh, look at Dante's eyes.
And that's
Oh, boy.
That's the secret ingredient for Dontay Khalifah.
Oh, man, he is a nasty dude.
Yep. That mean streak, and here it comes.
Oh. Look at that speed. Look at that speed, huh, Tim? How fast is Diego? Oh, he's so fast. Look at him. Oh,
and that's
wonderful.
That's the...
Where did that get him? Right on the canvas in the corner?
If you'll settle down for a second, let me finish the sentence. That's what Dante is doing. He's cutting off that speed and making the match his style.
Oh. Very physical. Oh,
wow.
Oh, Dante is one of the best.
They're bringing him up, sending him into the ropes.
Look at that. Oh, you want to get in the ring with Dontay Khalifah? Yeah.
Only a two count, but Dante seems to be starting to feel the momentum here.
Well, Diego was very flashy, you know, and he was having some success.
Oh, yeah.
But once Dante took over, he's just been relentless. And who do you think must be watching? Do you think Don Fierro's even, he's got Ken Magnum tonight, but he's got to be in the back of his head.
He should be.
At least seeing something or hearing. Oh, my gosh. Oh, wow. Slumdog Millionaire cut Dontay Khalifah.
Clothesline. Oh, my God.
Gosh, he's clubbing the stomach. He's clubbing the head. He's clubbing the neck. Wow.
Jeez, the speed again. Here's the speed of Diego Hill.
This has just been a war.
Oh, my God. And here he comes again. Why did Dante follows him in?
And look at that.
Went to the well one too many times.
Look at the look on Dante's face.
That Bulldog just turned him inside out.
Right on top of his head. Cover. Wow. The heck did he kick out of that?
I am amazed he kicked out of that.
Did you see him spike on his head?
He landed right on the crown of his head.
I know a guy that happened to one time. He was not very, very good. Ended his whole, yeah. Not good.
The guy I know?
He didn't get it on after that.
Not him. Another guy.
The guy, though. It seems like Diego has these bursts of speed, and Dante has to keep just swatting him away and taking over.
And you have to wonder.
Are you hearing this? This chance of let's go, Dante. Let's go, Diego. I mean, this is very evenly matched. Split crowd here. Who'd have thunk it?
Not me.
Dontay winning them over.
Because Dontay has not made any friends in this crowd.
But if there's a couple people that we've talked about here that are the breakout stars here. You got Don Furio. You got Peterbilt. But Dontay Khalifah, he's right there with these guys.
Dontay Khalifah is definitely on that list.
Oh.
Driving that knee into the midsection. Oh, boy.
Whoa, did you see the sweat? Oh. But Dante's not leaving his feet.
Back into the corner. Now here comes. Oh, he followed him again. Again. Diego
Hill.
Wow,
Diego just collapses in the center of the ring.
Going back to that same pattern.
But those chops to the chest. Look at Dante. He's having him wheel himself up using the ropes. Very physical contest between these two.
Wow. That elbow right across the throat.
Just snap. Oh, look at that.
Dontay is such an impressive athlete.
He's probably the most athletic guy here at Wrestling Evolution. Oh! Wow, float over elbow.
Innovative.
Yes.
Here's a cover.
Cover.
Only a two count.
Wow.
Yeah, these two are incredible athletes. Uh-oh.
Dontay just said, you come into my promotion.
You know all the way here from EA. You get shot there. I salute you. You know that?
Oh, I love Dante's just
talking smack the
whole
way.
I mean, who's the man? Dontay Khalifah. Let's be straight up.
Oh.
Wow.
Dontay. Rapid fire strikes.
He's still on. Wow, how upright Dontay is. Oh, that beautiful mill kick by Dontay.
Just took him off his feet. But Diego followed him into the ropes.
Incredible athleticism here. Look at Dontay. He's not done.
Oh.
Oh, Dontay. But look, Dante's barely still getting up. Wow, what gut check between these two. Oh.
Again, mill kick just followed Dontay up.
I'll tell you, there's one thing I've noticed about this match is Diego, he's been very impressive and very athletic, but he just can't seem to keep Dontay down. Dontay just keeps getting up.
Resilience of
very
Dontay
resilient.
Khalifah.
Oh. Whoa, look at Dontay.
Oh, nice reversal.
Nice.
Up. Heel trying to make his way. He's turning his head to get out of that choke.
Wow.
Impressive.
He's got those forearms right across the crown, but he finally gets out.
Now off the ropes.
What speed?
The clothesline.
Oh, my God.
And cover.
Oh, barely kicked out of the infrared. Wow.
That was close.
Very close.
These two men have got to be exhausted. They've set a pace in this match.
I'm going to drink some water here.
They've set a pace in this match that's hard to keep up.
It's hard to duplicate or replicate. I mean, who the hell could do that? This is the first time Dante's really been on the mat the whole match. I mean, this is really Diego Hill's time to just, to do whatever he has to do to finish Dontay off, who's not easy. The only one that's ever done it here is Peterbilt.
Both men trying to get their way to their feet.
Well, Diego's using the rope. Dante's getting up on his own accord.
Yep. He's standing there waiting on him.
Oh.
Yeah, forearm.
Diego was very flashy with those kicks.
Tornado
kick.
Beautiful.
Dontay is so intelligent. He rolls to the apron and to the floor.
Taking a little breather.
With Diego Hill, that's no man's land.
Yeah, that's true. Yeah, this may not be a
no. I sense Diego's about ready to take flight.
Dontay trying to make his way.
And
to his
here
feet.
We go.
Here he comes. Whoop. Whoa. Landed in a superhero landing.
Yeah, floats to the apron. Whoop. Dontay tries to sweep the legs. Oh, boot right to the face. Yikes.
Diego still up on that.
He's gonna go for it again. He may succeed.
Oh.
Tope.
Oh my God.
Right to the rope.
Right into the guardrail.
Wow, scoots Dontay in. Dontay is just flailing.
That was up close and personal.
Yep. Oh, ow.
Oh,
God. Axe kicked right to the back of the shoulder.
Very competitive.
Diego waiting on him to get to his feet. No, he's not.
Wow. Beautiful.
Oh, my God.
Spanish fly cover. Wow.
Wow. Only a two count. You have to wonder at this point, what are they going to do to finish? What are they going to do to finish off their opponent? What are they going to have to do?
I mean, man, this is... I mean, they've been going for quite a while, and it doesn't seem like any man's willing to concede.
No, neither one of these men. You're going to have to take them
literally
out.
Literally kill them.
Yeah.
Oh,
my God.
Jesus. Wait, I just saw a look on Dante's face. Did you see that?
Yeah.
Did you see that look?
Oh. He followed Hill in.
Oh. Oh, but Hill's still holding on. Barely.
Barely holding on to that top rope.
I think he's pissed.
Oh.
Oh, Dante. I think he might have just woke up the beast. Man, that chop was just overhand, just stiff.
Dante dragging him into the ring, get him away from the ropes, but Hill able to kick out. Dante is shocked, absolutely shocked.
And this crowd is on the edge of their seats. I don't think they ever see anything like this. I mean, we just saw Mason Allen and Tommy Okami go to war, and now we got this.
This is an impressive match.
He's going for it. He's going to finish him off. But no.
He's able to float through.
Whoa, slap. Another one. Oh. Paint brushes him. Oh.
Oh, high knee.
Look at Dante go.
Oh, oh man.
Wow, what a kick by Hill.
He just ate that super kick.
He's going for the cutter. Oh, oh. But Dante caught him. Oh, baby.
Oh, wow.
Oh, wow.
And it's sunk in.
He's rolling
deep
through on Dante.
Oh.
Wow. And what instinct by Dante.
He was able to roll out of it, but it was sunk.
Oh!
Lung blower.
No, code breaker.
Code breaker.
And I think he just figured him out. Oh, my goodness. I look at this. Hill's on Dream Street. Dante finishing him off. Cover. One, two. That's it.
That's going to do it. What an impressive match. Dontay Khalifah. You have to say this is one of his most impressive wins in this company.
And, he
and
is
that includes the ascension
impressive
contract. Wow.
Wow, what the hell
what
is Don Furio going to do if a guy like Dontay Khalifah gets in the ring with him?
And you got it. You got it. We talked about it before, whether Don was watching that.
Hey, look here. I am the Dontay Khalifah! And I am the winner of the Ascension match. I got the Ascension contract in the back. You never know. You might see a new champ tonight in the Khalifah of professional wrestling. Baba.
Wow, wow. Just Dante just flat out calling out whoever wins this match, whether it's Ken Magnum or whether it's Don Furio, Dante's in the wings waiting. Now it's time for the Wrestling Evolution Championship. Here's the challenger with Miss Exotic, the Loaded Guns, Ken Magnum.
Introducing first the challenger, accompanied to the ring by Miss Exotic. This is Loaded Guns, Ken Magnum.
And we saw it earlier. We saw the confrontation between Magnum and Don Furio.
Yeah, Ken Magnum looks extremely focused, but he's always focused.
Yes.
I mean, he's been around for 20 years.
You do not last for 20 years if you're not just that damn good.
And we see Ken Magnum making his way around the ring. Now let's take a look back at how Don Furio became the Wrestling Evolution champion.
But what you guys have failed to acknowledge is that the champ has been here since the doors have opened. As a matter of fact, I'm not the future. Damn it, I'm the present. I have done everything you set out to accomplish in the Carolinas. Either you're trying to do it or I'm already there.
Don't. You can either prove me and these people right, and that is, you're only half the man that Furio is, literally and figuratively. How about Furio versus Prince for the heavyweight championship? And if I lose, I will never challenge for the title again.
But just know, when it's all said and done, the most prestigious title right here in the Mid-Atlantic, laid right down on the line. If I beat you 1, 2, 3 in the middle of this ring, you never challenge for this title again. And you know what? You're on.
We got to the championship. Now here is the current Wrestling Evolution champion, Don Furio.
Oh, and he is super over with this crowd, Tim.
They love him. And Pat Frankie with him as well. As always.
Well, there's one man that stepped up against all challengers. It was Don Furio.
Oh, absolutely. He has taken on all comers here in Wrestling Evolution. Built his way up, made his way into the top of the card, and got his shot, and took out Christopher Prince to win the Wrestling Evolution Championship. All right, Furio.
You know, a lot of times when people win a championship, it can do one of two things. It could motivate you, or it could distract you. Don Furio seems like he's having a lot of fun out there, but you think maybe that killer instinct could be gone, Tim?
Well, that's a valid point. We'll because see. This is the first title defense. We'll see what happens.
Because you know Ken Magnum definitely has a killer instinct.
Oh, yeah. Without a doubt.
Without a doubt.
Thank you.
Man, Josh is having some trouble there lifting that gold. Might need to hit the weights, or maybe it's just that damn heavy.
Wrestling Evolution Championship on the line here in this match. Loaded Guns Ken Magnum and the Sicilian Assassin, Don Furio.
Oh,
wow.
Wow. You know, winning the championship sometimes is easier than holding on to the championship. I mean, he's standing across the ring from a 20-year veteran. As soon as you win that championship, no matter where you go, there's always somebody wanting to knock you off. And literally, there's a target, Tim, on your back.
Absolutely.
And if there's one man that could shoot a target, it's the Loaded Gun, Ken Magnum. And look at Ken, Tim. He's just staring a hole right through Furio.
Deadly focused. Deadly focused.
And Ken can play to the crowd, too. He's been around for quite a while.
They don't like him, but he can play to it.
I don't think he even cares.
Nope.
I mean, if you have Miss Exotic following you around everywhere in that outfit, would you really care who didn't like you?
That's a good point.
I wouldn't give a crap who anybody liked me.
Oh, boy. Apparently, Ken doesn't want the Don Furio. Doesn't want the Don Furio shirt. You know, that's just disrespectful.
Very disrespectful.
Josh had to pick that up. Yeah. Oh, boy.
Yeah, Don's getting under the skin of Ken Magnum.
Yep.
And Don's he's a very smart guy. I'll give him this. He's very charismatic, but he also knows how to play the mental game of wrestling. We're going to find out.
Again, the first title defense for Don Furio since becoming the Wrestling Evolution Champion.
Well, let's talk about some of Ken Magnum's accomplishments. I mean, former six-time LAWC champion, four-time APW champion, three-time HBW champion, one-time CWF middleweight champion. I mean, we're just talking about, like, the singles titles. I mean, he's done it just about all out there. Multi-time champion, Tim. This ain't going to rattle him. This ain't going to be, like, something that's going to, you know, get under his skin.
Yeah, he's been around a long time, done many, many things, wrestled many, many people. He's seen it all.
Imagine the trophy case that Ken Magnum must have. I mean, he's probably got so many belts and titles and awards. How many belts do you have in your trophy case?
I got a nice one I just got from Sears.
Oh, shit. Would you get really Gastonian nice. Sears?
Yeah.
Even Gastonian.
It's really nice.
It's brown. Hot dog eating championship. Let's get into this. Here we go.
All right. Furio off of the ropes and sends Magnum down to the mat. You got to look at the champ. He is
very relaxed.
He's very relaxed. He's the most confident I think I've ever seen him.
I mean, he's had to go through hell to get that title. Now he's got it. I mean, he believes that is his title, and he deserves it. Oh!
He went through a war last month with Christopher Prince.
I mean, wow, what an insecurity. Just goading Ken to get up.
Stalking Magnum, bringing him up. Throwing him into the corner.
You know, they always talk about the young lion coming out and taking out the old lion. But, you know, Ken, sometimes that old lion has a lot of bite left in him.
Oh, too. Yeah. You don't get to be an old lion without knowing what you're doing.
Absolutely.
Oh, he's got him by the beard.
Miss Exotic outside the ring disapproving. She don't seem very impressed with old Don Furio. What do you think?
No.
Got hands across her chest there.
Yep. Whoop.
Y'all better count with me. Come on.
Referee, Josh is barely even admonishing these closed fists in the corner. I mean, come on, Josh. Do your damn job. Magnum staggered.
Look at
no. Oh,
he is out on his feet. Right in the center of the ring.
You know, this is, you know, this has been all Don Furio so far.
Absolutely.
Uber confident. I mean, he's primed up. I mean, he's in the peak of his game right now. Ken floating him over. Can't get him. Look at Don.
Yeah. Sending Ken. Magnum over in the corner.
Yeah. That time he got him. Oh!
Oh, now Furio
right up
taking
by
him
us.
Up, taking him into the other turnbuckle.
Oh! Again by Furio.
Furio going up and over. Floating into the ring.
Furio is an incredible athlete. Look at that.
Oh!
Beautiful crossbody.
There's a cover.
Nope.
Oh, that was close.
That was close for as early as this been.
And the physique of Don Furio.
And we got guys like Peter Bilt, Don Furio, Dontay Khalifah. I mean, the list goes on and on. Not John Matt.
Miss Exotic inserting herself
and
into the
match.
She's
being effective. She's being effective.
I guess she's doing her job.
And we saw earlier how interference could definitely change the tide of any match and cause titles to be lost. Oh, catches the boot. Oh, aggressive clothesline by Magnum.
Now Furio trying to go for that super kick, but Magnum had it scouted. Right back onto.
Oh, look at Ken. He's looking right at Frankie.
Oh, geez.
Oh, yeah. I love it. I love it. I love it.
Coming through the ropes at us.
Well, I
don't need that kind of static. Huh? I don't need that kind of static. All right.
Beautiful shots by Ken.
Right into the ribs of Don Furio, taking the wind right out of him.
Wow, just a couple shots by Ken. Just kind of took the wind out of Don Furio's sails. Now look at Ken just getting that body lock on.
Squeezing right on the ribs that he was just firing shots into.
Oh, yeah.
Oh.
I mean, Ken Magnum knows every trick of the trade here. Cover. Nice.
Magnum losing his focus a little bit. He needs to keep on
losing his focus. What are you talking about?
Jaw with the crowd.
Look at that. Hooks him. Look at that suplex.
Oh, nice.
Beautiful suplex by Magnum. Cover. Look at that.
Float over into a cover, but only got a two count.
He kept that forearm right across the mouth of Don Fear. Just that little extra oomph.
Dan, you talked about the accolades that he's earned in his career. He's here for this Wrestling Evolution Championship.
Well, Ken's been a multiple champion wherever he goes. Oh, look at Miss Exotic. She's getting Frankie. Look at Frankie trying to ask Miss Exotic out on a date.
Trying to get
you
the digits.
Make me trying to get the digits. Get out of there, Frankie. What's wrong with you pervert?
All right, Josh finally.
Yeah, but he missed Don Furio getting just jacked in the throat. Did you see that?
Yeah, Furio.
Oh, look at Ken. Oh, this is where Ken really shines here, is when he just goes out there and gets nasty.
Yeah, Ken Magnum has a mean streak.
Well, he comes.
Here he comes.
Whoa! Oh, no!
Almost in our lap.
On the gooch. Oh, no!
Told you. Use the proper term. Perineum.
Oh, I thought you called the taint.
No, that's not it either.
Oh, is it the gooch or the taint?
It's neither.
Oh, no.
Perineum.
Maybe.
All right, Furio and Magnum both trying to recover now. Crowd trying to get behind Furio, trying to will him
solidly
up to his feet.
Behind him.
Both men a little wobbly, but up to their feet.
And you know Furio's all about just slugging it out.
Yep.
Look at that. Oh, right back to that throat. Ken scoops him up with ease, drops him. Beautiful.
Nice body
slam. Beautiful body slam.
Magnum's going up.
Oh, he's definitely ascending the turnbuckle.
Up to the second rope.
He might be taking too much time, Tim.
Here he comes.
Oh!
Yeah. Absolutely. Took too much time.
Furio able to roll out of the way. That could be a big mistake.
That could have been the break Don needed.
And here comes Furio back up to his feet. Magnum still crawling around. Furio starting to feel it.
Look at the look on Don's face.
Oh, waiting on Magnum to get to his feet.
Wow.
Knocking him right back down with clotheslines.
I mean, he's hanging in there with a 20-year veteran, and he's doing pretty damn good. Oh, collision. Wow.
Oh,
whoa.
Furio's up.
Whoa.
Yeah, he's hanging right in there with the 20-year veteran. You don't get to be the Wrestling Evolution champion by mistake. He's wow. earned it here. Waiting on Magnum in the corner. Here comes Furio.
Ken puts him on the apron again. Oh!
Furio through the second rope, now over the top.
Slingshots in, rolls him up. Ken rolls through, beautiful.
Oh!
Wow, what a knee.
Knee right to the side of the face, and here's a cover.
Wow. Holy potatoes. That was very close.
Wow.
That was like a milla lilla dilla badilla pandilla gooch. Millisecond.
Yep.
Wow, that was very close.
That was.
Ooh, yeah. I mean, wow. And good on Josh for just, you know, for seeing just the slip of the shoulder up. I can't believe we got it up.
Up.
Ken catches him.
He came in with the super kick, but Ken caught him.
Oh, that was stiff.
Wow, that rattled a tooth. Now bringing Furio up. Back into the ropes.
Shoots him off the ropes.
Reversal.
Wow, Ken catches him. Wow, look at that. Beautiful.
Now Magnum going for a cover. We may have a new champion. Furio's not done.
You know, the reversals here, that's 20 years of experience. Knowing where, it's like almost motion memory from Ken Magnum. But, you know, Don Furio may be the champion, but until you defend it one time, you're not undisputed.
That is true. That's a good point. This is his first defense. He has to walk out of here with that championship. Wait a minute. What's Miss Exotic doing?
Oh, wow. Look at this.
She's up on the ring apron, and I'm not quite sure what's going on. Oh.
She slapped Ken Magnum.
Oops.
Oh, no. That's going to be a discussion later. She gets home.
Uh-oh. Furio's waiting on him.
I think Ken's more shocked that it happened. She's trying to console him in the corner. That might have ended up being a big mistake.
Furio waiting on him, and there's the super kick. And that'll do it. Nobody's kicking out of that.
No, they're not.
And his first title defense, the Wrestling Evolution champion, Don Furio.
The magnificent Don Furio.
The Sicilian Assassin confirming what we knew, that he is a fighting champion.
Definitely.
He is our Wrestling Evolution champion.
All right, wrestling fans, we are moments away from the inaugural crowning of the new and first Wrestling Evolution Tag Team Champions. Of course, that match features the other guys versus my guests at this time, the Allen Brothers. However, gentlemen, I must remind you that you wouldn't even be in this match if it wasn't for the new legacy champion, Mason Allen.
That sounds like a lot of bias coming from you, because Mason didn't get us in this spot. We did. We got to the finals of this tournament. We beat the Kingsgate 1-2-3, and guess what? We already have a pinfall victory over the other guys. We did that, not Mason.
We all came here together, but apparently we take our separate ways. Mason wants to do his own thing. We're doing our own thing now.
I'm sorry. Ladies and gentlemen, the new legacy champion, Mason Allen.
One more time for me, buddy.
Yes, absolutely. The new legacy champion at Wrestling Evolution, Mason Allen.
Love that. Love the way that sounds. You know what? You know what sounds even better than that? The Limit Champion. That's who I am. You have an opportunity tonight. You're welcome, by the way. an opportunity to take us all to the mountaintop, for Allentown to be a trio of champions.
No. Listen, there is no trio in this. You left us. We're earning our spot. We don't need you, and we've never needed you.
Buddy, where were you at on those other wars we had? We had to do all that by ourselves. We earned the title of the best tag team in the Carolinas. Where were you at, huh?
By yourselves. We saw what happened.
Well, you've heard it from Mason Allen, the new legacy champion. And, well, this is going to be a very interesting contest. The Allen brothers versus the other guys tonight at Wrestling Evolution for the first ever tag team championship here at Wrestling Evolution.
All right, fans, now we're joined by the other guys who tonight take on the Allen brothers in the finals of the tag team tournament.
Allen brothers, tag team tournament final tonight. Tell them, Stu.
Yeah.
Are you guys okay? Oh, okay. Well, I mean, I guess they're really focused on the tournament finals tonight, so I guess we're not going to get any of the usual other guy shenanigans.
Ah! Oh! Gotcha.
What a good thing, Tim.
Oh.
Like spaghetti.
Oh, it's like have fun Sunday.
To the mountaintop.
Woo!
Oh, so come on, Tim. You didn't think that we were not going to be in a good mood. This is the tag team tournament finals.
We can make history.
That's right.
It's no mystery. We can make history.
What he said. That's right. And it's a big deal tonight. Us, the Allens, we've gone back and forth between them so many times, I can't even count. It doesn't matter if it's Tim Allen, Debbie Allen, all those Allens. Tonight, history's made. Doesn't matter which team. But I can tell you which team's definitely going to be on top. Ha, ha, ha. Ain't Allentown. It's who?
It's going to be the other guys, Keith. You know why?
Why?
Because
why?
We fight smart.
Stu, don't stick that.
Sorry. We still fight smart.
And we party hard. Okay. Not this hard. But until then, party time!
Okay, back to the ring. All right, now it's time for our main event of the evening, the finals of the tournament to crown the first Wrestling Evolution Tag Team Champions and the first competitors are the Allen Brothers.
These guys are so damn annoying. You like these guys? Because they pat you on the back.
Yeah, they came by and said hi.
One Allen brother won gold already tonight. Ken, two others. We will see.
Yeah, will it be the Allen's night tonight? Or will the other guys come out of here as the champion?
Oh, Jesus.
Here come the other guys, to the delight of the crowd.
And by the way, you kind of neglected to inform me your little silly string incident earlier.
Oh yeah, we had a moment there.
I thought you just had dandruff.
All right, the other guys making their way around the ring. Like we said, we thought they were really focused, but...
No, you thought they were really focused.
I thought they were really focused.
I always knew these guys were just absolute damn goofs.
That silly string was really cold. I don't know what's in those things.
If I get, like, warm crotch, I can just spray it out. Yeah,
if you want to. That's between you and the Lord.
You know, I don't really know why the other guys are doing this. Pandering to the crowd over a pair of goofy glasses, stupid hats, and headbands.
I mean,
they are going for the tag team champions.
The Allen Brothers brought
Look at those belts. Look at the belts.
They're beautiful. I love them.
But they're going to pander to the crowd.
when it should be razor focused. I mean, a fan of the Allen brothers here, but you know, at least they seem focused.
The other guys feed off of the crowd. They get more power, if you want to say that.
Power?
Yeah, from power. The crowd. So, yeah, they do interact with the crowd.
I thought you said powder.
This contest is your main event for the Wrestling Evolution Tag Team Championships. Introducing first the team to my right, from Allentown, Pennsylvania, Robert and Steve, the Allen Brothers. Introducing their opponents. From Mother's Basement, total combined weight 10,200, number 2 pencils, Keith Mack, Stuart Snodgrass, the other guys.
All right, here's our main event tonight.
It looks like we're going to have some camaraderie.
Up.
Which makes me sick. I don't want to get in there. If I was either of these teams and beat the hell out of the other one, uh-oh, decimate them.
Oh, the hips are going.
Do we have to see this? The man through five. Do we have to see this, Tim?
How are you still confused by this? Of course we have to see it. It's the other guys. All right. Show of respect from both teams.
Speaking of which, this will be our third title match of the night.
Yep.
And who won the Legacy Championship? By the way, I kind of forgot.
Mason Allen. Oh,
there we go. It was Mason Allen. That's right. Yeah, Mason Allen.
What I said.
Okay.
And now the Allen brothers, Robert and Steve.
And I don't understand. I don't understand these guys. I mean, Mason's a winner. He knows how to win. Why wouldn't you want to align yourself with someone so smart and so successful? It just blows my mind.
Well, you know how families are. Brothers are
more like they're stuck with each other.
Well, yeah, that's true. Oh, well. Now it's a party for everybody.
Yeah, boy.
It's all in the hips.
Yeah, definitely that.
Late, great Chubbs Peterson.
Late, actually. Very late.
Oh. Ah. The Gator got him.
No, they say he died of a heart attack last week.
Well, yeah. But the Gator got him long ago.
Got his hand.
That's right. Well,
they threw him out a window.
Yeah, exactly.
Nobody's going to have any idea what we're talking about. Nope. All right, guys, let's get back to the match.
All right.
Main event of the evening here at Wrestling Evolution Aggression, the Allen brothers and the other guys. Now, Tim, if you had to be a betting man here, who would you bet on?
You know what? I think this is kind of an even bet. I mean, I know that sounds like I'm just avoiding the question.
I would have normally, on paper, bet on the Allen brothers. However, they're so damn stupid because they will not listen to reason.
Wow.
So if you're not going to listen to reason and you're not going to take good advice from Mason Allen, I mean, how do you expect to win if you're not that kind of aggressive soul? So, I'm not saying,
So you're saying that you think the other guys are going to win?
I think that they have a better chance. I'll just say that. And I'm not a fan of the other guys.
I know
but
that.
But this tomfoolery has been successful before with the Allens.
Hey, Keith Mack,
Wow, he's going for the Texas tumbleweed. Wow, shades of Terry Funk. Who'da thunk it here at Denver?
That's how we roll. All right, catching Robert in a side headlock.
Very elementary here, which is a good thing. Oh, it's kind of a feeling out process here between these guys. They're no strangers to each other.
Yeah, they know each other extremely
well. Very well.
Oh.
Yeah, we're crisscrossing here. This is eventually going to Keith back. Just, now he's going for the log roll. Oh! Oh, my God.
Oh, wow.
He landed right on his head.
Right on the
forehead. My God. That looked really, really bad. I'll tell. Oh. Hey, Yeah. Let's be honest about something. The Allen boys are tough.
Yeah. Yeah, because he fell right on his forehead. And Keith Mack.
Wow, just
flipping Robert. Oh.
Yeah.
And Robert trying to make his way over there, making the tag to Steve.
I don't know if this is a really good matchup either. I mean, Steve's giving a lot of size to Keith Mack.
Yeah, he really is. Oh, Stu wants the tag. And here comes Stuart Snodgrass.
He's very impressive. I mean, he might be a little smaller, but he's very confident in his abilities, and he likes to go around and have fun in there. He's very, very inventive.
I think he's very much the ring general of the Allens. Steve seems to always have the plan.
He seems very cool, confident, and in control.
Wow.
Uh-oh. I don't think that Stuart liked the side boob chopped like that.
Uh-oh. Stu's hulking up.
Again, like I say, this is definitely a feeling out kind of process between these two. Just, wow, he goozled him.
Oh, flipping him back into their corner.
Right into the corner.
He just manhandled him.
And he sprung him out. Keith didn't even have to touch him.
Oh, here comes the slingshot.
Yeah. Look at Keith. Keith's got the boot up.
Right into Keith Mack's boot. There's a cover.
It's going to take a little more than that.
Yeah, it wasn't
going to
be that easy.
Steve Allen. He's a good guitar. He's a good piano player, by the way. That's true.
Wow. Count along at home, kids.
If you can here in Denver.
Whoa!
Wow, what strength by Stuart. Yes! Kurt Hennig special. That is probably the only thing I think that Stuart does I like.
Stuart, he's calling for the...
Do we have to?
This never turns out good.
It never Stuart. Works. You're a complete... Look at that. Ow. Steve didn't even let him get it off.
Right to the hamstring.
Had that move well scouted.
Wow, Steve Allen's wearing out that hamstring.
He's going to have to ask Mom for those ice cubes in the Ziploc bag when he gets home.
Uh-oh. Whoa.
Wow.
Look at the muscles on Stuart Snodgrass.
Look at that. Oh!
Who would have thought that?
Did you see the ring shake?
Wow.
Wow is right.
Maybe Stu's been working out, getting ready for this match.
Really?
He's rearranging his comic book collection. Yeah, he's got to move those boxes. Yeah.
That finger strain going out.
No, I mean, those boxes get heavy, man.
Yeah, okay.
Well, they do.
You would know.
Okay? I would know.
I used to have a celebrity skin collection. I highly recommend.
Sure.
What's wrong with that? It's a very nice magazine, okay?
Very classy.
Very classy. Good articles.
Now, really fast tags in and out by the other guys, keeping the pressure up on Steve Allen.
You know, and usually in during title matches, which we've already seen so far twice tonight, people just go for broke. But the other guys, that's not really their style. They like to get in there, kind of mix it up a little bit, and it kind of wear guys down, and then just really speed it up, you know, in the final stretch.
And that's the thing. You know, we have a lot of fun with the other guys. The other guys.
You have a lot of fun with
the
them.
The other guys have a lot of fun. But one thing you cannot dispute is the fact that they are an incredibly effective tag team.
Well, they're very successful, I'll give you that, which is why I picked them to win tonight. Oh! Half-star frog splash goes for the cover.
I'm just glad that you're able to that you're a fan of
the other guys. Wait, first of all, I never said that, okay? I would never say that. They're complete buffoons and idiots.
But you like
him. No, I don't. I don't like him, okay? Because he got that stupid hat with the doily propeller on it.
Oh, okay.
Those glasses. Wow.
The hat's nice.
It's not. It looks like it's just ridiculous.
Oh! Wow!
Wow! Very resourceful by Steve.
Steve just slipping out of there and bringing Keep Mack forehead first down on that turnbuckle.
The only reason I'm so hard on the Allens is because, I mean, Mason has offered him the olive branch how many times, and they refuse to take it. For what? Okay, have they been successful? No. They've been moderately successful during this tournament, and the only reason they're in this damn match is because of Mason Allen.
Well, you got a point there.
Yes, I do. But instead of going out and thanking him and saying, how can we, you know, tell us more, wow, they just admonished him. As you saw earlier, he even asked him tonight, and they still, no dice.
Yeah, they didn't want anything to do with that. But yeah,
do you like money? Do you like money?
I really like
money. I like money. Do you like, you know, oh, that was beautiful.
Nice. There's a cover.
Wow, Keith out it too. But I mean, you like money. You like
success.
Money,
yes. I love success.
You know, you like being acknowledged, you know, by your peers.
Yep.
So why? Why wouldn't you just do whatever you had to do to accomplish that? Which is Mason Allen. Everything he does, he's been successful at, okay?
That is true. I got to say, I mean, he's undefeated.
He was successful tonight.
He's the new legacy champion.
He's the new legacy champion.
Keith Mack trying to sneak
through. He knows
what
he's doing. But no, let's not listen to that. Let's just sit there and have goofy pride and you know, care about the fans who, by the way, are the fans paying their paychecks? No. Tim Wilcox is. And champions get paid more than anybody else.
That is true.
Now, unless you're selling gimmicks or hot dogs or,
well,
you know,
the other guys do
services.
Sell a lot of gimmicks.
Huh?
The other guys do sell a lot of gimmicks.
But they're not champions.
Well, not yet.
But
they
could.
Might be.
I think they will be tonight. You think they're going to raise the rates on their gimmicks if they win the title?
Oh, of course.
Really?
Of course, man.
See a child. Wow,
oh,
that was quick.
Wow. The speed of Steve Allen as he followed Keith Mack in. And here's a cover.
It's been quite back and forth. I mean, the other guys were pretty handily just tossing around the Allen brothers. And now the Allen brothers, likewise, are doing the same to the other guys. Quick tags, cutting off the ring. Very even match right here. But it comes down to who wants it.
Yeah, absolutely.
And if you want it more than anybody else, you're willing to do whatever you got to do. Like Mason Allen.
Boy, you were beating that dead horse.
Well, I mean, that's just the truth. Is it not the... Wow.
Whoa.
Who'd have thought? Who'd have thought some fluidity by Keith Mack?
That was impressive.
That was very impressive. Kind of like watching a walrus do a gator roll.
Wow.
What's wrong with a walrus?
That was descriptive.
You know, let's give a little credit to our camera guys. And look at Action Cliff right in there just getting those facials from Keith Mack.
Best in the business right here.
Best in the business is getting those facials. Oh. Yeah, we love you there, Cliff.
Now Keith Mack making his way to his feet, trying to get out of this.
You know, maybe can help me out here. Championship matches, they give you a lot more time than normal. They don't, because they know how just important
it's
these
important.
Matches
yeah.
are.
Oh!
Wow, both men down.
They are down. Keith Mack's taking a lot of punishment there with that desperation move. He needs to get the tag to Stewart.
And I've noticed that Keith ain't wearing that arm brace. His arm was broken.
Yeah.
By the Heart Killers, and he's now 100% lucky for him. Look at those bionic elbows by Stewart.
Stewart is cranked up tonight. He's got the yellow hip.
But imagine what's on the line here. Being the first ever Wrestling Evolution Tag Team Champion. They're going to be only one.
Oh, now see, this is what we were talking about. This never goes well. Robert had to stop it.
Yes. And Robert is the powerhouse of the team.
Oh, he's doing it. Oh.
Wait, what?
What?
Are we going to have duel? Are you serious? We're going to have dueling? We're going dual.
Stereo airplane spins.
Oh, my Jesus.
Oh, boy. Now everybody's dizzy.
Help me. Help me. Oh. This is Steve just wanting to get off the ride.
Oh. Everybody's down.
Steve just wanting to get off the ride.
Oh,
Bobby. Wait a minute. Kindred's here.
Here comes Justin Kindred.
This could be the game chamber right here.
What is he doing out here?
Look at the referees. He's definitely giving him a lot of leeway. He knows what's at stake.
Well, the reason that Mason Allen came out the legacy champion tonight is Justin Kindred.
Well, hold on. Mason earned that title.
Yeah, after Justin Kindred.
I absolutely have no idea. Oh!
Oh, boy. Ouch.
Whoa.
Ow.
3D. Oh. 3D.
3D. So
I don't know what Kindred was trying to accomplish. Look, here goes Mason Allen.
Here's Mason.
You know, he's just taking care of Kindred out here. I mean, I don't know what the hell Kindred was thinking. Now we got a total breakdown of all men in the ring.
Yes, this is quickly getting out of hand here. Mason's talking to Justin Kindred over there. But Robert's off of the rope, but
oh! DDT by Keith. Yeah. And look at Steve just trying to jog position, but he just doesn't have the strength to, whoa!
Uh-oh.
They're going for the heart killer. Stuart nails it. Oh, this has got, wait a minute, look at Mason.
Charles Fuller's over there with Mason.
Yes. Look at the crowd. Oh, they don't like this at all.
Charles Fuller, referee, is over there with Mason Allen, missing the cover here.
What is going on here?
Stu had him covered for like 7-8 seconds. All we needed was three.
Look, Keith on the outside, just kind of pulling himself up.
Stewart is upset.
Steve is just in the ring. Where's Robert?
I don't know.
Oh, look at that. Look at that. What the hell just happened? Did you see Robert pull Keith down? Wait a minute. Hold on a second.
Oh, here they go.
Look at this.
Oh!
Total elimination. They did it. Whoa, wait a minute.
Wow.
Hold on a second.
The Allen Brothers.
Here are your
winners.
Hold
on a second.
And the first ever Wrestling Evolution Tag Team Champions.
Wow.
Robert and Steve.
Oh, there went a streamer.
The Allen Brothers.
Robert and Steve, the Allen Brothers, are the first ever Wrestling Evolution Tag Team Champion. Steve and Robert and the other guys back in the ring. Now everybody back there, Mason in there, Justin Kindred. Whatever, the Allens just handed the titles to the other guys. And the other guys gave them right back and are raising the hands of the Allens as the winners. But what's the status here? What's going on with Justin Kindred and Mason? Mason and Justin Kindred talking to the Allens, and Robert Steve don't want them there. Oh, wait a minute! The Allens just plastered the other guys with the belt. It looks like they were with Mason after all. And the Allens are standing tall, and for the love of wrestling, has become the Allen Show. For this event, you have to say all roads lead to Allentown as Mason Allen comes out the legacy champion, and Robert and Steve, the Allen Brothers, are now the first ever Wrestling Evolution champion, tag team champions. So at the end of this night, the Allens are on top, and it looks like Justin Kindred has finally earned his stripes to be an Allen. I guess helping them win both titles
is enough to make him get him past the honorary Allen title and into a full Allen. Robert and Steve, the Allen brothers, are your new Wrestling Evolution Tag Team Champion. Mason Allen is the new Wrestling Evolution Legacy Champion. And that's going to do it for the love of wrestling. We'll see you next time here from ringside.